shoes.
Nah, niggas wore the. Nah, I wore the button up with the S. Dot Carters.
Man, I ain't.
Why you do that to yourself,
green
bro?
Ass nigga?
Hey, I'm glad you did it, bro. Why the fuck did you do that to yourself?
I learned to change clothes video.
Oh, I seen that is clothes. Not a good reason,
no,
bro.
No, see, that's why. That's why I want to stand as you get a fit all. Like probably not in retrospect, but like in back in the day,
in the time.
No other person was inspired by change clothes enough to buy a pair of S. Dot Carters.
Nigga, I had some S. Dot Carters, but I got them from the
niggas had S. Dot. I didn't, but niggas had them all. Now.
Niggas did have S. Dot Carters.
I had some G units.
The G units
was hard. I'm not gonna stunt.
When he was in like the little warehouse and he was working out and shit. Yeah. I seen that shit. I said, ooh, mom. I need these.
That black cement colorway that nigga had. Them shits is cold.
I'm gonna tell you why I thought the G units was hard. To me, and I shouldn't say this on air, but they had the aesthetic of like a Stan Smith to me, if sure. They would.
Well, that was, I think that was the, well, that was the S. Dot Carter approach.
Right, right, right.
Try to go for that.
But if it would have, like, G-Unit had a strong push behind them at that time. Mm-hmm. I think if it would have developed a little more, that would have been a lifelong shoe.
Yeah, you know, I think the first G-Unit shoe was, it was the Rod Lava mold. Mm. And the second ones, I thought they looked like some Jordan 4s because of the netting.
Oh, I see.
You remember
what
was the S. Dot Carter original mode? I can't remember offhand right
now.
The
original Gucci shoe.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That rap he did with 50 was hard though. That he was like, the shape of the original Gucci's. I just switched the soles or some shit like that.
Yep. Nah, niggas was not wearing no dirty ones though, bro.
Nah.
Them Nelly ones.
Nah.
Nah, I remember one time a nigga wore the Hurricanes, the game ones.
The 3-10s.
But we ate that nigga up,
bro.
3-10 Motorsports.
Nah, that nigga was. He had the nerve to have on the Hurricanes.
Did he have on the white jersey?
Nah,
the Hurricanes were disgusting.
He had on a white and red one, but then the nigga had on a G Unit tank top in school.
Oh,
I remember this.
He was
set
tripping.
Oh yeah, he was tripping, bro.
I think it was only like.
It was a light skinned nigga.
It was only like two people, two or three people that had a pair of Hurricanes. Bro, from I know he was ahead of my class.
I don't know if Russell remember this, but when that nigga had it on, we were like, bro, that's your brother, nigga. Because it was a light skinned nigga. We were like, Russell, that's your brother. Because the nigga.
Russell has caught so many strays for being light skinned, it's ridiculous.
It used to be this one nigga that was in the other. I don't know if he remember this. He was like a grade ahead of us. They legit looked like that nigga's brother. Like, they look like the same thing. But that nigga with the G units on, bro. The nigga had the G units. First of all, you can't wear tank tops in school.
Bro.
So this nigga just chilling with the tank top.
Bro, no. Wolfson, niggas was getting away with some shit.
That G unit tank top, boy. That shit was a dark time, boy.
It really was,
and the big ass capris, boy. That was an era.
Oh, them capris! Oh, yeah.
The capris, bro. If you ain't own a pair of capris, you wasn't a real nigga.
Yeah, everybody had a pair.
Nigga wore the capris, bro. With the straps,
with the straps.
Hey, bro. Nigga walk up on you in them capris, you know what time it is.
I hated the ones.
Like, hey, we
straight.
Been a box.
No cap, bro.
Coogee capris.
No cap. I went to my uncle's crib one day. He let me borrow some Jabos. So I was like, all right, these bitches hard. So I put them on. They was capris, bro.
Oh, yeah, that was a... What the white force?
I was like, bro.
Nah, the nastiest fit ever was when they niggas had the Kuda, like the Teal Coogee. With the Teal Coogee capris.
Oh, my God.
And then you
The Havana Joes?
No, not the Havana Joes. You remember when they did the Fusion Forces?
I do.
Jordans?
And was a disgusting time.
Yeah, the five. And niggas had the Easter.
Every
Easter
fit
ones.
Looked like, yes, every fit looked like Easter Sunday, bro. Plaid.
Niggas had
the plaid, plaid capris with the fluorescent polos.
Yeah. That shit was insane, bro.
That was a nasty. That's that Young Dro time. That's that Young Dro era.
Oh, that's why you hate Young Dro so much?
Probably, bro. Probably. That fit, like, that fit era was nasty, dog. And I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I had a pair of Fusion, man. But,
Which ones you had?
I'm glad I dodged that bullet.
I never had one. It was one pair that I gave slight respect. It was the cool grade 12 ones. You remember the ones I'm talking about?
That's the one I had.
Like, them, they was like the really...
They was
like
gray. The, they had like they a, like a quick ice block, ice yeah. bottom.
Oh, the Dummy Head had them bitches. Yeah.
Them the only ones I had. And I thought the colorway was cool. There's no excuse for owning a pair.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the last episode of Random Ass Podcast. We did 360 on y'all boys. And I think that's enough. I think this podcast is ran its course.
Hey, look, man.
I'm gonna shake
your head.
Hey, man.
It's been good, y'all boys.
I told y'all.
It's been a good run.
I had a couple.
Held it down.
I had a couple moments in my life. Wait, ooh, I'm embarrassed to say. You know, I told y'all my mama bought me them FUBUs. You know what I'm saying? I had to wear them bitches. You know what I'm saying?
That's nasty. But I respect it. Yeah, my pops had some FUBUs. He had the nerve to, you know, when you had the fire shoes, you had them bitches on the bed.
I ain't never set them out. Man. I ain't never set them FUBUs out, man.
I might be the only, I might have to get the green ass nigga, but have y'all ever had a chick over at the crib?
And you had to hide the FUBUs?
No, nigga. Now I'm talking about when you got the fresh shoes.
Let me
had the shoes on the bed. You ain't never did that shit. I might be the only green nigga.
You know what? I used to play green ass nigga.
I hated playing.
I had the burgundy fives. The chick came over, had them bitches on the bed.
I ain't gonna lie.
You got the new Jordan?
I got the new Jordans.
You like it? I just came from Iceman. Mr. Kit got the burgundies.
Nah, you ain't the only one because
look at you. You hit the green button and you.
I'm about to pull up one of my least, you know what I'm saying, proud moments.
Oh man,
I had all them bitches on the bed. I had all of them. You know it was this was the MySpace era, man. I had to let folks know.
You got the picture?
Yeah.
This nigga was taking.
I told y'all, man, pictures. my photo bucket still alive. You know what I mean?
Photo bucket.
Yeah, bro.
You still remember that account,
bruh? I don't know how. I don't
That's
know how.
Crazy.
This nigga really a photo bucket right now. This is
these
crazy.
These fits are crazy.
This is insane.
But them burgundy fives was just ridiculous. Yeah, shoes just all over the bed. I mean, mama should have beat my ass.
That's
hockey.
Yeah, you was on 23 is black a lot, bro.
Yep.
Man, that was my screen.
Yeah.
That was my screensaver.
That was my shit right there.
I ain't gonna lie. I checked that bitch like the news.
Sure, every morning, nigga.
I used to be in class.
Did the release date change? Like, the release days don't change.
Who was on 23's back? Devin was on media takeout and shit.
Bruh, you are not lying.
He was all it, nigga.
This nigga would give you random facts. Like, bro, where did you get that? What news outlet was this? A nigga on media takeout?
You heard Rihanna was from Pluto? Like, no, nigga, I didn't hear Rihanna was from fucking Pluto, nigga. Only you heard that shit.
And I be believing his dumb ass from time to time. Like, damn, nigga.
I was trying to think of some more nasty fits, man. That's about it, man. The nastiest fit event ever was always Grad Bash.
Oh yeah, boy. I never got to go to Grad Bash.
Pinwheel fitters was nasty too.
Was that a thing down here? I feel like that was a New York nigga shit.
I seen a couple of niggas.
I ain't seen many people. Hey, this gotta be my, like, this is the funniest picture.
Oh, bro, I remember that shirt, bro.
Put that away.
Bro, I think this was like my 10th grade year, and that was seniors.
Yeah, I still remember the roast. They were like, y'all niggas split the package?
Yes, bro. That shit was, and it wasn't playing, bro. I ain't know this nigga was finna be wearing the fucking.
Everybody wore their shits that week, bro.
Yeah.
Everybody, bro.
Because everybody had to wear because my senior year, everybody wore the ones, I think the yellow ones, the Grad Bash. So everybody had on the yellow Coogee fit.
Yep.
It was either those, the King County Spazikes.
Yeah, oh, not the Spazikes. I hate it.
The Pure Monies and the Black Cats.
Oh, yeah.
I never understood how folks could be mad about the Fusions and like the Spazikes.
The Spazikes almost caught me slipping. I almost bought the King County ones.
green ass nigga.
Come on, bro. You just had the shoes on the bed, bro. At least when I put my burgundy on the bed, it was dead stock. So ain't had no down dirt.
I mean, hey. A nigga washed the sheets, bro. I just couldn't show a bare mattress.
That's crazy, bro. But I definitely had this. I definitely had the sneaker. I mean, the shoe pick on MySpace with the boxes and shit.
Oh yeah, for sure. Did it every which way. I had them stacked up to the desk height. I had them stacked up to my height and shit. You know what I'm saying?
I still remember to this day when that nigga had took Joe's shoes and that nigga Joe called me.
Oh, bruh. Bruh, I was ready to light the fucking block up. Man.
Nigga stole your shit,
bro. Bruh, I'm at church. Oh, I was hot. I think I called everybody and was like, oh, a nigga finna die today. What's going on? Somebody done hit me for my Jordans.
That nigga called me like, Amp, I'm going to jail. I'm like, what? God. Like, a nigga done stole my shoes. I was like, damn, bro. I don't know what to tell you.
I lived on the base. I was walking outside. Matter of fact, I remember this shit. The nigga that stole him talked me out of it. He was finna catch the hell had I known it was him.
You like, please don't kill me. I mean, don't kill that nigga.
Like, for real.
Think about your life, young bro.
That's exactly what he was saying, man. Think about it, man. Da, 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 da. I'm on the phone while he telling me this. I'm like, hey, man, I'm outside your house, man. Bring that chopper outside. I got a ski mask on and shit. And nigga say, man, bro, just think. Take a deep breath.
That's crazy. Like, bro, nigga, you a little too invested, bro. Let me see, right. Let me see your house. Yeah,
my dumb ass talk about, man, this nigga looking out for me. Yeah, good. When I found out it was him, I pressed every nigga that was around him. That nigga was gone for the army the next week, bro.
Like, I would have enlisted so I could see that.
Oh, nah, I prayed on that nigga. Like, I hate to say it. I used to pray that nigga stepped on a landmine. Oh. Boom. Blow that nigga legs off. I want to see that nigga Lieutenant Dan when he come back. I'm going to help that nigga to his table. Like, what's up, bro? Where we eating today? Set the plate in that nigga lap. Like, hey, fuck this nigga, man. Bruh, for years I prayed on this shit. I went to church one day.
Imagine him like, Lord.
The back.
Please, Lord.
Lord, please blow this nigga legs off.
Bruh. And I mean, for real, I say all my prayers, God, get my blessings.
I want to see this nigga legless.
Please, he just never should have took my shoes.
That's probably why I be going through shit now. God be like, hey, man, you an ugly nigga, bro. You an ugly nigga. I got to punish your ass.
Damn,
bro. Bro, for real. I'd be like, hey, look, Lord, I thank you for all that you do. I ask that you please forgive me for my sins and the sins I'm yet to commit. And that nigga that's in that army, that nigga Thomas, let that nigga be walking through the desert. I want him to be in conversation, Lord.
Oh, my God.
Talking to his man. And next, boom! It would just play in my head as I'm saying a prayer.
Hey, bro,
I'd be thinking about different places he could lose his legs.
Like, you say
that nigga could lose him in Kuwait. They could be gone in Afghanistan.
Dog, I can't see, bro. I got tears.
They could blow one to Africa.
Oh, shit.
Ship the other to me.
Bro, that's crazy. You say you're going to pull the nigga. You say you're going to pull the nigga in a wheelchair to the
yeah. Yeah. Yeah, bro.
Where we eating today?
Set the plate in that nigga lap, bro. Here you are.
You know it'd be crazy, the shoes he stole. Like, get the baby shoes and time.
Oh, bro. Bro. Here you go, man. Hey, remember these. I reminisce.
Bro, I'm real crying over here, nigga.
Bro, I'm telling you, man, I had a dark time, man. A really dark time. And I was crazy as hell back then.
I respect it, bro.
I was crazy as hell.
You got baby
hell.
Shoes around your neck. Oh, these the shoes I stole from a nigga.
Yeah. These are why I lost my legs.
Bro, see my fucking face, man.
Bruh. I'm telling y'all, man, it was a dark time.
Can you just imagine this man praying to the Lord, thanking you for all the sins that he's taking for us, bro?
You know what I'm saying?
And then his only request, not to cover his family's blood, For in the blood of Jesus. His only request was to make sure these nigga 2 feet were blown the fuck off.
Knock his legs off. For real, bro. And I would have been dancing on that shit.
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah, stepped on a landmine, nigga.
Damn, a lot, bro. That is officially funnier than the Pokemon Sick Boy. That was officially the funniest shit I have heard on this one.
Man, look.
I respect it, bro. I would have been like, man, I just got these J's. You want to try them on? Look them straight in.
Bro, I think that nigga hit me for like 16 Jordans, bro. I came back to the house.
Somebody seen that shit,
though. No, matter of fact, it was 20 pair of Jordans. I came back. I'm rummaging through the few that's left, and I had a gang of forces. I mean, I probably had like 30 pair of forces. None of them touched. None of them touched. I said, oh, this a particular nigga. Yeah, don't
just,
worry.
He just wanted all the J's.
Yeah, my prayer was real specific. Real specific.
That nigga really came by there with a whole suitcase.
Matter of fact, I should look this nigga Facebook up, see if he still got his legs. Yeah.
But that's a prayer you can only get answered in Creflo Dollar Church. Nobody else church but that nigga.
Yeah, right. You probably got to pay $2,500.
Oh, yeah, the custom pastor. Oh, I got you. I can handle that right now. Custom pastor, I need a special sermon today.
As a matter of fact, I seen that motherfucker last week.
I need that fuck nigga Rob today.
I'm gonna say the prayer with you. Lord, fuck this nigga and them legs.
Oh my God. Oh shit.
Shout out to the custom pastor. We need him on here, boy.
Yeah, bro.
We do. That'll be fine, we do. Bro.
Shout out Miss Custom Pastor for keeping him in line, too.
Bro, that's crazy. Call him right, Miss Custom. He was like, introducing Mr. and Mrs. Custom Pastor. I'm like, bro, what's your last name? Your last name, not Custom Pastor.
That shit be killing me, man.
That's funny as fuck.
First time I seen that shit, I said, nigga, what?
Yeah, the internet is ridiculous right now.
Oh, my.
Oh man, we got Malk on. We didn't even introduce our guest, man.
Not at all. We just dove in.
We got the homie Stan on. He ain't been
Stan the motherfucking man.
What's happening? What's happening?
We got the mayor on, bro.
I popped in. Stan told me he was coming, so I pulled up out of nowhere. Niggas had no idea I was at the door.
I don't know. I had a strange feeling you was coming. That's why I had the fourth mic ready. The fourth mic was over there.
Yeah, hey.
So yeah,
I ain't know.
I had a feeling I was gonna.
That's
pull
why
up.
You podcast man.
Right, that nigga always prepared.
Yeah, so you know when Malk come through, got his entrance music. It's a little late, but fuck it, man. Y'all ready to sing? Let's get it. All right.
I'm never not ready to sing.
Yeah, you always singing, dude. You need to stop
singing it. Shut up.
The South gon' hold it down. The South gon' hold it down. The South gon' hold it down. The South gon' hold it down.
Son of a bitches.
It never gets old. It never gets old.
Shout out to that nigga, bro. I heard that nigga work at
Kid. You gotta dance like that nigga.
Or hit the south side like Paul Wall.
Fresh pair of J's with the B-Light. Like. Yeah, get off me now.
What was that nigga name, bro? It was a Dallas nigga.
It was a Dallas nigga. And his homeboy had the shag, the Dallas shag.
The booty cut.
Yeah, only them niggas can wear that.
That shit is wild, bro.
Yeah, that shit was crazy. The booty cut. What was that one nigga name? Not Duro. He used to be Tom Tom.
Man, Tom Tom and Fat B. Come on, man.
I don't know about that. I just know Tom Tom.
Wait, that's that was the group. Ricky Bobby? Is that one?
Tom Tom. Tom Tom was the Capri song.
Yeah.
Jen, buy the shit.
Man, Tom Tom got some records.
Oh, Tom Tom could spit back in them days.
Come on, man. On my screens is still one of my favorite records. I mean, shit, we get into that Texas music, man.
Oh, you know, you know what I'm saying? Shit, Southside the Realest is one of the greatest Texas songs ever made.
Come on, man. Come on.
Dallas had a couple of them back then.
All right, Joe. Our first sponsor, Manscaped. Shout out to the big homies.
Shout out.
At Manscaped.
Much appreciated.
So Father's Day is coming up, so.
June 20th, ladies June 20th,
to be exact. Get on your shit. You got a couple months. Get prepared. So with Manscaped, they're offering 20% off on your on a purchase off manscaped.com. They got all kind of shit. One of the main things I seen this week that they were advertising were their ball wipes.
Oh.
Yeah, so.
I ain't hip to that.
Yeah, so if you're a little musky down there, copy some ball wipes.
I work hard. I might need to grab some of those.
So if you need to grab some of those, use that promo code R-E-O-P. Get 20% off on that purchase, man.
Now, I would like to remind everybody that Manscaped does have this smooth glide, fellas. So, I mean, get away from your razors. Get away from your clippers, your everyday usage. I mean, this Manscaped, one time, you good. Definitely does a good trim all around. It's smooth. Like I say, one of the best things about it is what all comes in the package. So if you have the time, go to manscaped.com, browse around, take a look, see what works for you best.
Yeah. Destroy those. If you're using those big razors, man, you're a Neanderthal. Throw those big razors.
You hate yourself. You
throw those big razors away. What they call, like a dollar? So yeah. You get about 20, you before, get, 20 yeah. of them bitches for a dollar.
They hand them to you in a hefty bag.
Throw them shits away. Get you a Manscaped razor. And if you don't want to get the Manscaped razor, you don't want to clip your balls up. They got nose hair trimmers. They got all kind of shit. T-shirts, all kind of stuff.
2021, it's all about grooming. You know, we want to make sure that we're presenting ourselves in the best way. And as we appreciate ladies, you know, being cleaned up down there, you know, we might need to do the same.
And any ladies, like Joe just said, any ladies that's listening to the podcast, if you want to hook your man up for Father's Day, and if he ain't put a baby in you yet, get that Manscaped kit, and he will, so he can be a father for next year. So, once again, use their promo code R-E-O-P. Get 20% off on manscaped.com, and that's it.
Shit, the whole state of Texas, like, you really didn't lose.
Oh, no.
You really didn't lose in the screw era.
Oh, no.
I hated Mike Jones.
Yeah, oh, man.
Mike Jones was ass.
I didn't say that.
Yeah, bro, but you was ready to say that. Here you go, hate nigga. No, Mike Jones was the worst nigga in the screw era.
I just know about Mike Jones' album, and he owed me $10.69.
Nah,
that shit was not good. That had a bunch of old songs on it anyway.
That nigga owed you a phone call. You just ain't called in, bro. Never got that's what you paid for.
I called him.
Oh, you called him?
Yeah. He went straight to the
post. I heard his number still works.
Nah, he just got it back last year. That's but the funny thing is, let's call him right now.
Let's do it.
All right. What's the number?
281-330-8004. Hit Mike Jones up on the low, because Mike Jones about to blow.
I'm slow as fuck. It's 28, what is it?
281-330-8004. Come on, man.
This nigga better answer, bro.
Bro, he said that shit in like
every record.
Every two lines, bro.
He probably out
there. That bitch busy, bro.
Yeah, bro, the world calling. The world calling, bro. COVID done. They want to see Mike Jones back.
Man, nobody give a fuck about Mike Jones, bro. That nigga better answer that phone, bro.
You ain't lying. What you doing?
He be like,
Ned.
Snappers fishing chicken.
He working in Mr. Snappers.
I called that nigga Jamal the other day. Jamal Shakur. That nigga say, hey, thanks for calling Pizza Hut.
What?
Hey, all right. Oh, God. You lucky I wasn't smoking.
Green ass nigga.
I'm sorry, Jamal. You got it. You got to take that, bro. What are you doing? No. But I respect it, bro. That's crazy, man. But another episode of Random As a Podcast. What we going with this, man? Like, really?
Man.
It's 360 in this bitch, man.
360
episodes, man.
Damn.
Jeez, 360.
Dog.
Bro, that's a whole circle, bro.
I remember the very first one.
Come on, man.
I don't remember. What was the first one? Biff. Biff was the first one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Biff, And Biff was a great episode. Yep. Biff was
a real good episode. Yeah, y'all niggas on episode 100. That was the most ignorant episode ever. Yeah,
you can't even listen to that shit.
No, you can't. It's too chaotic. Some of the stories that happened, because that's before like the live stream stuff was going around. So you only could hear things like, I think it was you or Jordy was upside down in the chair.
That was me.
Yeah, upside down in the chair.
Niggas had no podcast etiquette.
Oh no,
there was like four different conversations going on at once, bro. Niggas was drunk as fuck.
Ryan cooking grits in the kitchen
while making a good.
Nah, there was peas, bro. Yeah, that was black eyed peas.
Oh yeah, he was making black eyed peas.
Motherfucking fish was walking themselves out the tank and shit. And nigga Jordan was out cold on the couch
the whole time. I heard
Devin threw up that same night, right?
Yeah, I believe that. Devin always throwing up
right there.
He always throwing up.
That nigga got a story throwing up for every situation.
I only seen him throw up that one time. That's crazy.
The concert?
What concert?
The
Kid Cudi,
yeah.
No, he passed out.
Oh, he passed out that night. Yeah, okay.
One Quan that
night. All right, I might be putting something on. I might be putting lies on.
Quan was on because we had ran it back like a couple days later. And Quan was on.
Yeah,
that Quan.
That was the second one. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I tried to get Quan on a couple months ago, man. Quan, you owe me an episode.
Man, that nigga Quan be
heard it here.
He busy.
Nah, that nigga. Yeah, he be like, man, I'm about to pull up.
That nigga be like, yeah, I'm DJing.
Cap. Damn, stay where, around the corner
where you at, bro? That nigga be like, yeah, man, I'm DJing at somebody's living room. Like, nah, I'm bullshit.
Yeah, come on, Hollywood, man. He won't pull up, man.
That nigga stay down the street, bro.
That's what I thought. I was like, yeah. Hey, man, we right around the corner, man. Come on and pull up on us. That nigga say, hey, man, I got busy.
But you know.
Nigga doing a push up, man. Get your ass over here.
You know a nigga is lying to you as soon as they say, but you know.
But you know.
I know what, man. I know
you,
what.
You know.
Like, nigga, I know nothing, nigga.
I know your ass wasn't here. That's what I'm gonna start saying. For real. All right, so, man, let's talk about this Babe Ruth shit.
Yes, sir.
Are you talking about Babe Ruth being a nigga?
Yes, sir. The truth finally set free.
First, let's start by talking about this. All the great home run hitters are black.
Oh, I mean, have they officially started putting those stats in from the Negro Leagues yet into MLB?
Oh, they inducted all of them into the Hall of Fame, but when I don't think they added the stats.
No, they're not adding the stats, and they said they weren't. If I'm not mistaken,
I could have sworn they said they was going to bring... Like, those stats would be brought over.
Really?
Because they bring them bitches over.
Yeah, they bring
half of them bitches going to be in the
man,
top 15.
Man, it's going to be ridiculous. Yeah.
Them shits nasty.
That's probably why they didn't pick nobody for the Hall of Fame this year. They were like, man, fuck yo.
I could believe that 100%.
Bro, it's so hard to get into that shit, bro. Like,
yeah. It is. Because they take so much into consideration.
Man, no, they don't, bro. They were like, bro, you put a needle in your arm. Yeah, well, fuck you, nigga. Okay, like the whole league was shooting up, and they were like, nah, fuck you.
Yeah, that's real. That's real.
So, yeah, I don't respect that shit, but yeah, this nigga, Babe.
I don't respect any of them award shits.
What?
Well, the NBA's probably the only.
A lot of the honorary things that we have, like award shows, these Hall of Fame events, because a lot of them do spite niggas.
Yeah, only awards I respect are the Ghetto Grammys. That's the only one. If it ain't the Ghetto Grammy, I don't give a fuck about that shit.
Only one, Ghetto Grammys.
And the Ozone Awards.
Duval Diamond Awards.
That's the one I want.
And Real Niggas of the Week.
That's the one I want right there.
Yeah, oh, you respect the real nigga of the week?
Yeah.
Oh, real nigga
of the week? Oh, yeah. I never.
That's the best one.
I try not to knock anybody real niggas of the week. Sometimes I do question.
I don't know. You had gave JoJo Siwa your real nigga of the week one time, bro. I don't respect that.
When I did.
I made that up. You had to think about it, though. Did I give JoJo Siwa my real nigga of the week?
Hold up. I don't even know. Only time I've ever seen who she was randomly dancing. With no music
playing. I know I gave
the
baby his they need their ass beat when he dissed her. Yeah. Like, you a bitch, JoJo Siwa.
Yeah, that was.
I don't know why he did that.
That's still
that shit crazy. Still don't make no sense. Why that nigga got braids? That shit don't make no sense.
The baby got braids.
Bruh, yeah.
That's, I'm laughing so hard. I seen that nigga the other day, and that nigga had dreads. I'm like, why does this nigga got dreads?
Woke up one morning, that nigga, the top of that nigga head was braided. I say, I thought this nigga had a boozy face.
Bro, that is funny, bro.
Y'all questioning why this nigga got braids. Hey, I was looking at that nigga. I'm like, bro, why this nigga got braids, bro?
That is insane. Look, man, you get money, you do shit, you know.
That is insane.
That's the only way I can think of it.
Rest in peace, Cam Go Hard all the way. Also.
Oh, ooh, shit, yeah. Cam Go Hard. He did pass.
Yeah, he got hit with the fin pad.
Oh, yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, y'all stay away from that shit.
Yeah, that's so don't buy them drugs in Charlotte, whatever that nigga was living at, bro. He got the fentanyl in it, man. So be careful.
And the four, yeah.
But yeah, back to Babe Ruth being. So what is he, Dominican or something? That nigga look. This look like a nigga right here, bro.
Yeah, it definitely look like a nigga right there. Yeah.
And he was looking at Harlem nose, a lot, bro.
Yeah, he was hanging out in Harlem a lot.
I can believe Babe Ruth was passing.
You go his pops right here on the left.
Yeah, they say he was passing because his skin was like super light and shit.
Yeah, he was so pale. Like,
did somebody put them Amazon frames? Jordy did that.
Yeah, Jordy. He put the bumps on them.
And what he said, somebody called him baby face.
Baby face Ruth.
Baby face.
That's funny. That's funny.
We might have to steal this for the camera, bro.
I'm
about to put this on a baseball card, bro.
Nigga put Cartier frames on
them.
They got the buffs on them, bro.
Bro, this nigga is so clean, bro. Look at this
for
nigga.
Real. I'm just slapping homos.
A fresh pair of buffs on.
How you hit the home run and the buffs don't fall off your face,
bro? He black, bro.
He just sitting that shit to heaven.
He might be black.
That nigga too cool. They probably got a picture of that nigga smoking a cigarette at the plate.
Shit, his nose is probably holding them bitches up.
Yeah, the big ass nose, yeah.
Cause you gotta think about it, dog. Like, how many niggas, well, how many white people you know named Babe, bro? It's just like a black nickname.
It sound like his nickname. Yeah. Like, always got called Babe. Yep. Look at the way this nigga held the bat, bro. Like the nigga that don't know how to play baseball.
For real.
It does be swinging that shit.
The way that nigga ran and all that shit.
That nigga killed some dominoes in the dugout. All right,
yeah, he didn't run.
That nigga ain't run shit. He was banging them bitches.
Babe Ruth didn't run, bro.
That nigga had to run.
Baseball was back then. He used to go and steal third base.
Bro, for real. Like, his whole body would be moving like a fucking cartoon.
Babe Ruth just started tagging
this motherfucker out. He 265 pounds running from third.
Smoking a cigarette.
Like, come
Babe
on,
Babe Ruth just stole second and third. The fuck? This nigga ain't even running, though.
That shit is
it's insane.
Like
ass baseball.
I didn't see him coming. Some fucking train running at you like this.
Imagine him doing a slide, bro.
Oh, he would have tore his ACL.
Imagine a refrigerator sliding at you. Like, no.
All that nigga ligaments just tore out the bone.
Yeah, no, sir. Like, bro, tagging him out? Shit, you no, dead. Sir. They got an ambulance on site?
Yeah, all your shit. What's that nigga named Kevin Ware that broke his leg?
Yeah.
Like a Beirut leg look like that. That nigga try to slide.
You know they ain't playing with no kind of insurance neither. Oh, like.
You remember when that nigga Byron Leftwich used to try and slide? He used to take that nigga like.
Bruh, it was a three-step process getting down.
That nigga there, bro.
Byron Leftwich, that's crazy.
Right, Shout out to him getting his ring. Though.
Yeah, he did get a ring.
He did.
He coached him.
But that's the Jaguar curse. Well, blessing, I guess. You leave the Jazz, you get a ring.
Blaine Gabbert got one too, don't he?
Yeah,
he does. Damn.
Blaine did get
one. Yeah, Blaine and Fournette got one this year.
Fournette got one for reasons I ain't going to explain.
Yeah, it's a conspiracy to that.
Yeah. Oh yeah,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, it's a
one of the wildest conspiracies.
If you know, if you know, that's all I'm gonna say about that.
Like, oh no, nope.
Just know it ain't football related.
Shout out to the Memphis Grizzlies.
Leave it at that. Gonna leave it at that.
Oh man, back to Beirut being. Anyway, in this picture, like he say, I know Black Poppy.
Right, he definitely would be saying,
I know Black.
Me amo.
But like this, over the years, when I see the pictures, I was like, bro, something just don't seem right, bro. And then Jesus Mero kept talking about he was Dominican. Bro, we got proof he was Dominican. I was like, bro, it makes some fucking sense, bro. When you look at this nigga.
Well, here's my thing. Name me one white person that they ain't trying to build as a superhero, right? And when I say that, what I mean is they give you this all-around aspect to where they're such a good person, right? Only thing I know about Babe Ruth is baseball.
That and the damn candy.
Well, yeah.
Yep, that's it.
Yeah. But I say that to say you hide shit when there's something behind it.
Oh, yeah. Huh?
Who else was Black? I know they said Abraham Lincoln was probably Black.
Yeah.
I think it's like a fact Abraham Lincoln was Black. Like
it
they
is.
Did a DNA test.
I've seen some shit saying Beethoven could have been Black too.
I could believe that. I could believe that. Now, one reason why I could believe that, Beethoven was deaf and blind, if I ain't mistaken, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
Okay, so never mind. I'm not even going to go there.
Go ahead. Let me look up this nigga Beethoven.
Which one is the
But I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all.
Y'all know what you blame just on me.
Musically what inclined. You blame on me.
No study, no thought, no input.
Look in the mirror, what do you see?
Okay, you see it clearer. I'm thinking this a Black thing.
I feel like this is a crazy take, but what you believe.
I'm only human after all.
You saying my take is crazy or Dr. Umar's take was crazy?
After all, don't put the blaze on me.
I don't know, it gotta be something.
Don't put your blaze on me.
Hey man, it's a cracker.
Some people got real
rock. I'm looking at Beethoven. This is a cracker, bro.
Hey, bro.
He ain't got no melanin in his skin at all.
Bro. Hey, bro, that's a painting
look
you
at
looking
his head.
At.
Right here, though.
That's a painting you looking at.
That's looking a little different right there.
And not just that. How they painted Jesus?
All right here, like his name could be Peabo-Toby.
I ain't comparing them to. I'm just saying.
Hey, bro, white people be whitewashing.
Slick Toby.
Come on, man.
Slick Toby.
Come on, man.
They changed his name. They ain't say Beethoven. They said it's Beethoven. They said Beethoven was Black.
Yeah, good thing we got footage of Michael Jackson, bro.
Right.
Oh yeah, that would have been nasty.
Yeah,
that would have been real nasty. I'm glad we got him cripping too. Did you see him throwing up neighborhood in that one video?
Well, I think
did you see that shit?
I did.
Well, it's a known fact, Michael Jackson was GD.
GD?
Yeah.
Man, put me on game. Matter of fact, I'm going to wait for that.
He's from Gary, Indiana, bro.
True indeed.
Banging, bro.
It was banging, bro.
I got to read up on this. Apparently, this is like...
I definitely heard about
Beethoven,
him pressing
great, this. Great, 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 great grandson or some shit like that. Nigga, this look like fucking...
They got on buffs, too. What the fuck?
This is like Mount.
Yeah.
It look like Mount, bro.
Put the glasses on, Mount. Put the glasses.
Hey, look, bro. Hey, look, dog.
Oh, hey. Shit. That look like Mount.
Damn, brother. You're
wrong. They told my granddad.
That's crazy.
Shit. Oh, shit.
This is more crazy because this shit was like written by the Guardian and this shit. They did not spell Beethoven right at all in this shit.
Bro, that shit does look like me a little bit, bro.
That's crazy, bro. You might be related.
Why
to
is
Beethoven.
There a picture of Malcolm X in this article?
I don't know. I gotta read it up. I don't know.
It might have been friends or something.
Right. Malcolm X was moved by Beethoven's.
He came in up. Oh, brother.
So, man, this is interesting, man. I wonder. Oh, nah, they got this other. They were like, this is actually Beethoven. I don't know. Like a nigga drew that shit.
Look at that head, bro. That's a nigga head.
It's crazy. It ain't necessarily straight. I mean, it could be island, bro. Like I said, look at that forehead, bro. You got a Barbados forehead.
That's wild.
Yeah, they look like a braid out, bro. Like Allen Iverson got his braids and took them out.
He definitely got a cranium.
Yeah, he got a dome.
Bro, that nigga Beethoven head, but you.
Oh, well, it's over with, bro. You catch concussion, bro.
It's over with.
Concussed is over.
Yeah, you talk shit about his music, bro.
You're bound to have an aneurysm in your life after that. Yeah, like, yeah.
Nah, they saying it's Beethoven right here, too.
Oh, that's a young Michael.
Oh, that's a young black man right there.
That's a young Michael, shit, bro.
Look.
Nigga, this like one of the DeBarge boys right here. Like Beethoven like El DeBarge, bro. This nigga Beethoven black, bro. This is crazy.
Bro, look at these black ass pictures of Beethoven.
Nah, right now it's clearly Frederick Douglass.
I'm only human after all.
Again.
I'm only human.
I'ma go back to saying. Don't know too many white folks.
Don't put your blame.
Don't tell me no Bob Dylan, no or no Elvis Presley.
Take a look in the mirror. What do you see?
I don't wanna hear none of that shit. Them the only two they can name musically.
And what you believe?
You listening to ones right now? Rag and Bone.
Well,
yeah.
You know only.
He done been around for almost 200 episodes now. But that literally was like one of y'all first drops.
Yeah.
They used to play that. They used to play that before we even had to drop shit. Shout out that nigga Ragged Bone. On 400, we need him and some strippers.
Like live, bro.
That'd be nuts. Seek Almighty Mike.
Seek Almighty.
Seek Almighty Mike. GPS.
Seek Almighty. Live podcast.
You know, it's funny. Jamal said, he said we shouldn't bring Seek, man. He probably a plan to kill us, especially if we don't plan to pay for that pussy.
Bruh still calling y'all?
Yeah, I blocked that nigga number. I had to block his number.
Hey, look at him, that nigga edit shit in the chat. He turned nigga that show.
He does, actually.
All right, so DJ, I was about to play DJ Larry voicemail, but DJ Larry said Michael McDonald and Hall & Oates.
Yeah.
Is white people.
Oh, now you know what? Yeah, Hall & Oates.
Hall & Oates had them fooled, boy.
Hall & Oates?
They had your food now.
Oh, my God.
They had your food, nigga. Don't act like you knew they was white. Oh, they my had your food,
God. Man. Hey.
Man, one of them motherfuckers ain't white. One of them motherfuckers got John Oates?
Yeah.
Daryl Hall clearly a white man.
He Puerto Rican or something.
He got, I don't know, bro. That nigga got the S Carolina mustache.
That nigga was an extra Miami Vice.
My friend, how you say? I want you to smile a while for me.
Now look here, bro. He ain't all the way white, man.
Could you imagine that?
Well, Michael McDonald though.
Nigga singing a Marine Gay version of Sarah Smith.
You know how British folks will sing like they're American and like all of that shit. And a lot of countries really, like a lot of foreigners can sing English really well. He'd be like, my friend.
What you say?
My friend, what's that song? What's that song you say?
Enrique, that song you sing.
I mean, look at his height, bro. Go back.
With that bird.
Go back.
Which one? This one?
Yeah, bro. He a 4'10 Puerto Rican, bro.
Oh yeah, that nigga short as fuck.
I didn't realize he was that short.
Nah, Daryl Hall probably standing on a box.
Yeah,
I don't know, bro.
I don't know if he that short.
I might be the only person that ever seen this, but this nigga Daryl Hall literally got a TV show where he like in a garage and he sang music in his garage. In like one episode, nigga had Smokey Robinson on there with a do-rag on.
Was he singing that Crack His Wax song?
No, nigga. He was singing Ebony Eyes for some whatever reason. He was singing, he was high because that nigga had on a do-rag and he was singing his parts and Rick James' parts. I was like, bro, why you singing this song, dog?
That's funny.
Rick James show. And Rick James was alive at that time. I was like, bro, Rick James show beat your ass. You singing both? Why you singing both y'all niggas' parts?
Smokey Robinson in a do-rag?
Yeah, that nigga had a do-rag on for whatever reason, bro. That bit was Tyler. He was Tyler. It was Tyler like an undercover cop. And you know, those niggas, you supposed to tie the do-rag in the front. That nigga Smokey Robinson had the do-rag just tied in the back only. But that's better than tied to like a one of them new niggas. And how they had that shit.
Oh, just, how it be in the front?
Yeah, that bow in the front.
Oh, yeah.
All right, man. Don't fall, man. You know, I seen you, man. Yeah. But yeah. Who else y'all think it was probably like black and they trying to hide under the low? It's like, because it's like, nigga, like, how many people, how much like historical things y'all think they just like hide and just lying to us?
That's a good question, bro. I could believe it's a lot. I mean, I'm saying I could believe it's a lot. I know it's a lot. I could believe that it's so much that we would be lost if we really knew.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, wait till we find out aliens exist, man.
And I say that just because, like, it would be an overwhelming amount of truth. It'd be an overwhelming amount of well, damn, now I gotta reassess so much about history that I'm reassessing things about myself. You know mm-hmm. what I mean?
For sure, for sure. I mean, a bunch of American history is a lot anyway. That shit ain't nothing but a white people highlight tape.
Very true. Very true. I never understood that in middle school. I never took history class in high school. So in middle school, what I never understood was, why don't we hear about the only black person they want to tell us about is Martin Luther King, and it's still a skewed vision.
Yeah, because they whitewashed the shit out of bro.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you tell me how at the end he became more radical. You don't talk about right. how Malcolm X, you know, made his transition.
Right.
Right. What did they just talk about? They talk about MLK. They talk about Harriet Tubman. And that's it.
And I don't even know why they talk about
Harriet Tubman. A lot of people didn't know about
that's not their place.
A lot of people didn't know about learning about Fred Hampton until that damn movie came out. Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, that's true. But yeah, that's unfortunate, honestly.
Shout out to what's the brother's name? Daniel Kaluuya.
Yeah.
Shout out to him winning an Oscar for that. I don't know. Why was people mad? Because he won a supporting actor. And like people mad because they felt like he should have won the best actor. And I was like, that movie was really about the snitch, nigga.
Right.
More than anything.
Right. He wasn't a lead role. So
yeah, yeah, it wasn't.
It wouldn't be fair to take away from somebody to give it to him. Though he had the best performance.
He's still a supporting actor.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Rand just brought this up in the comments. He said, didn't y'all say J. Edgar Hoover was black? Apparently, Banks was telling me about that. I didn't know that shit.
You never heard that?
I never heard it. Like, J. Edgar Hoover was a black man?
Yeah, J. Edgar Hoover was black. And what I always heard was that.
Fact or was it just like a rumor?
To my knowledge, it has been proven. But I always heard that he did so much against black people because he was trying to distance himself from the fact he was black.
Mm. Oh, so he was a coon. I got you.
Yeah. Well, no, he'd be more than a coon. Mm. He got to be. Shit, we got to come up with a word.
I think coon fits.
Nah, bro, he a cockroach.
That's worse than being a coon? I guess. Bro. I don't know, bro.
Yeah, bro. Because they don't die, bro. And white people, man, we not going to go there.
Well, yeah, let's get into these voicemails, man. Mm-hmm. Hit us up with the voicemails. Just call 424-260-REOP. That's 424-260-REOP.
Yeah, bro, I started to steal your shine.
I ain't stop you, man. But let's get into this first one. It's from, actually the only one from this week. It's from DJ Larry, so let's get into it.
Man, what's going on, man? It's your boy DJ Larry checking in one time on the Random Acts Podcast. Y'all know this is the best podcast in the world. Subscribe to the Patreon if you want to be a real nigga today. I got a question, and it's going to be like an ad kind of mixed in one for the voicemail today. So I know that with the Patreon, we get, you know, different things when you get, you know, different tiers, and, you know, when you reach a goal, certain stuff happens. Like, the next goal is the RAOP tattoo. But since we never got Eric and Devin's face, since Eric want to hide out and shit, I know Complex got sneaker shopping with Joe LaPuma. Can we get suit shopping with Joe Jefferson for RLP because this nigga Joe love to pick out different extravagant color suits and shit. So for the people who haven't subscribed to the Patreon, what can we expect,
that would be fire,
you know, in the future when it comes to RLP tiers? Y'all boys be safe, man.
Alright. That's from a joke.
Hey, look.
You gotta find a suit shop. You gotta find a suit shop. Say I'm down to record that shit, dog.
If we, say
wait, is Brothers 2000 still open?
Yeah, it's still open. Still
Brothers 2000?
So what I'm thinking I'm gonna do, though, is this. Because I do get asked where I get, you know, where to get the suits.
Man, nobody ask you that shit,
bro. Bruh, stop it. Nobody ask you. You a hater, bro.
All right, let's just stop it right now.
When niggas don't wear suits, bro, you don't get asked questions like that.
I don't wear suits. I don't wear suits, bro. I got you. Nobody asked me where I get my black tees from.
Yeah, bro.
I got you, bro.
Because they $5. All
right, so I'm sorry I interrupted you.
So I have been thinking about doing like a little post to where, you know, I go through different tiers of, you know, affordable to more expensive suits and, you know, just even considering customs and getting them tailored, things like that, cost to consider, mm-hmm. you know. So that would be cool. Suit shopping with Mr. Jefferson, that'd be cool. Where we at on the Patreon list currently?
That'd be fun. I'm pulling it up. I really forgot where I even would look to find that. I got it ready. All right, so next week I will not be on the podcast because of my birthday next week and I'm going to be out of town. So Bank's going to be standing in for me on that. I don't know where to look for that shit at on here.
He know we was going to punch his ass 32 times.
32.
Yeah.
Nigga, I'm not Machine Gun Kelly. You remember that nigga? What was that nigga? Machine Gun Kelly got punched in the chest like...
Oh yeah, I do remember that.
Then they got punched in the chest 62 times. Yeah, to cancel that shit. I don't know where the shit at. I know I owe y'all, so if we got the 125 Patreon, we've been got past that. I got to sing DMX, Get It On The Floor. So I got a DMX t-shirt.
Okay.
It's on the way. I'm going to wear that. And then when I come back, I'm going to sing that. I think 200, if we get 200 people, you got to get an R.E.O.P. tattoo. I had to go on a date with a white woman, but the client.
We all getting a tattoo?
Yeah, got to get a tattoo.
Okay.
Got to get the R.E.O.P. logo. All
right, that's a bit.
I forgot what it is after that. I forgot how to bring that shit up on here.
So where are we at currently? How many Patreon subscribers?
135. Actually, 131.
All right. So we had 131. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to the Patreon at 200. We're going to be flashing the tats. You know what I mean? It's going to be a big year. We're going to definitely get a lot going. I know that with DJ Larry mentioning that on air, you know, before we got a chance to talk about it and think about it, I'm committing to it.
All right, so.
Yeah, that'll be fun. Yeah.
We have to fly Joe LaPuma out. So since Eric worked with Complex, he got to make that happen since he won a slap box.
Yeah.
He got to get us in contact with Joe LaPuma. And make that. I'm trying to find this shit. I think it might be right here. All right, so 125 was Amp has to sing DMX, Get It On The Floor. So I got to sing that, and I got to do it right, because if I don't do it right, DMX going to haunt me in my sleep for the rest of my life.
You don't need that. And you wake up to right.
Where my dogs at?
Right. Him and Jet Jackson, bro.
Stop it, bro. I don't know why you put that.
Damn, bro. That'd be a horrible mess. All
right, so that chair right there, that little chair, right there, that used to be in my room. I had to take it out. And when Stan said that, I swear to God, I woke up one night and I seen Jet Jackson in that chair.
Oh, bro. I would have burned that chair, bro.
And I had to get that chair out.
I would have burned that chair. I would have mentioned that over here. Dog.
Yeah, that should have been.
It was somebody sitting in that chair, bro. Yeah, oh, let me get this chair out
of
here.
Nah, man, that's crazy.
Damn, bro, my bad.
You said Jet Jackson.
So you got one nigga playing a damn detective and the other nigga giving you prayers in the middle of your sleep.
That's crazy, bro. Damn. So 100 was Devin and Eric was slap box. Of course they didn't slap box. They both hold out on that one.
Yep.
Them boys ain't real.
Then yeah, 200 R.E.O.P. tattoos. No face tattoos, of course.
Yeah, no face tats. I ain't getting that shit on. I ain't getting the Nelly tat. You know what I mean?
Nelly tat?
You know where he kept the Band-Aid? That's the only place I can think about.
Green-ass nigga.
I wish that was louder.
Yeah, bro. I'm glad it wasn't.
There was a fucking Band-Aid, man. It wasn't no tattoo.
I'm just saying, like, I ain't getting it in that position. You know what I mean?
I might have hit the button again, bro.
All right, don't do that.
Shout out DJ Larry
Let me dodge this
for that voicemail, man. Let's get into listener questions. To send in listener questions, just hit us up, mail at raopodcast.com. That's raopodcast.com. So, Malk, you actually sent in a question for us, and you just happened to be here. So, let's go ahead and get into that one first.
Oh, I forgot what it is.
Malk asked a Jacksonville question for y'all boys. What side of town is Arlington on? So, I feel like this is a great discussion because niggas are confused. I feel like anything past the bridge is the south side.
It's yes. The south side.
Yep.
Yes. So, look, how I judge the city is this. Once you cross... I still consider Mandarin the south side.
All of that.
Everything. So until you cross the Buckman, the Matthews, or the Dames Point, you're on the south side. Mm-hmm. Now, once you cross Kernan, in my opinion, you're on the beach.
I can see that.
Yeah. Yeah. I consider the beach the south side.
I don't. I consider the beach its own entity. And the reason I say that is because... realistically speaking, you got people that don't have to leave the beach.
Well, the beach is another county, right?
It's not another county.
No, it's just its own city.
It's on, yeah.
That's basically like saying Orange Park is the west side. I get you.
Yeah, I consider Orange Park the west side.
Yeah, it is the west side to me.
It is. It is for sure, because that shit connected to Argyle, bro.
Yeah. Dad and now Oakley.
So yeah, well, I think if you, no matter what bridge you cross, if you cross that bridge, you're on the south side. Yeah, but technically, ain't it the east side?
If no.
You just want to be technical.
If you on a compass, Arlington. If it's on a compass, it would technically be the east side. But
yeah, you got to think about it. Downtown is technically the east side.
True indeed.
Arlington connected to the east
side. Downtown the east side, and then Arlington is like right there.
Because Arlington is connected to university. Atlantic.
Fucking Wonderwood. So, I mean, like...
even Regency, technically, because it's on the other side.
Realistically, like, from Arlington, you can be damn near on any side of town, like, at its starting point.
Yeah. No, I'm talking about, like, in right 10 there, minutes. Once you pass the bridge.
Yeah, yeah, but just right hear there. Me out. Hear
Cause,
me out.
Because some Arlington niggas... claim they're north side, and I don't know what they...
What?
Like the top of Monument is... damn, it's down to the north side, though.
I could give you that. But I wouldn't. And the reason why I say that is, ain't you still got to cross a bridge. Got to cross a big-ass body of water. This ain't no, you know, little pond we talking about. You know what I'm saying?
Damn Atlantic Ocean.
Like, bro, I'll never forget. Somebody once told me, Jacksonville's beach doesn't connect to an ocean. And I had no words for them. I was like, all right.
Does it not?
It does, yes.
It does, okay. So, it's just remedial.
As fuck.
Dumb okay. As fuck.
You don't respond to people like that. I was like, all right. But long story short, I would consider Arlington the south side. Anything across any of those bridges is south side. Once you get to Kernan, I feel like you're on the beach.
I dig it. It was specifically actually because of, you know, you spent time in Arlington and all that. So it was.
I live in Arlington.
Yeah, it's Dan stayed in Arlington for a minute.
And then I lived on the beach. You know what I'm saying? So, like, you got to think for
don't
the
say
people.
No more.
Bruh. I ain't lived on the beach in...
you should be ashamed for living
15 years. I was a child.
You a beach nigga, man. That's crazy. You a shoobie.
I was in Arlington before I moved to the beach. So, I mean, yeah.
That's crazy, man.
Nigga, shut the fuck up. Some old nigga. In the hood, nigga.
What was that movie?
Crack needles on the ground.
What was that movie? Inkwell, with a nigga lived on a beach? That's Joe biopic.
Man, shut up. I've always been a south side nigga.
Nigga had a beach house, bro. That's crazy.
I mean, like I said, I spent my days on the beach. I went to middle school while I was on the beach.
That's crazy.
I went to Justina for elementary, Mayport for middle, and then Wilson for high school.
That's so crazy, because like, you used to live all the way out there, and niggas used to go to your house like every day. I'm shot my car and explode.
Bro.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Mayport so far.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. And I mean, on the base. Like, I mean, not on the base, but like, I was right outside the base.
Right there.
Yeah. I was right there. And
that ain't no regular ass drive, bro.
Nah.
No.
And I'm going to tell you what. One day, this is one of the craziest stories I got. Me and this nigga Russell was out somewhere, and or was it me and you? I can't. It was a gang of us. Everybody was out. Let me
say the
that.
Story, and I can remember.
I think it was Russell. So I'm like, yo, I need you to take me home, man. I just stay right up the street, and I think we was like downtown or some shit. And long story short, it ended up being a 30-minute ride back to my house on the beach.
Oh, that was Russell, because I would have threw you out in my car.
It was like, man, this ain't down the street.
This ain't down the street.
I was high. I was lost. I was like, all right, hey, look.
Yeah, Mayport far as fuck, bro. I stayed on Bay Meadows, and that shit was still far.
Yeah, yeah. Anywhere you're at, Mayport is far. Unless you're on Monument, on Wonderwood, like right near Wonderwood, or Kernan, or San Pablo,
or that part of Maryland,
for real, mm-hmm. Like, bro, Wonderwood is—Mayport is not close.
Yeah, because when I used to go over there, I used to go like down Merrill, and like I ain't know shit was past that wall. That Walmart used to be there. Mm-hmm. I used to think that shit would be like, you remember on video games how you do go in the map off. And it just cut off?
Yeah,
I thought that's how that shit. I thought past Merrill. Damn, map just cut off
for like, a long time. Like, what in that?
Shit
went
past this bitch.
Yeah, Merrill long as fuck.
For a long time, it wasn't nothing over there. Then they built that Publix, and then they just developed the hell out of that shit. They got no damn Popeyes down there now. Yeah, they got so much land they building on. Yeah,
Fort Carolina. Yeah, all that.
You know they running out of shit when they build a Popeyes. They put a Popeyes anywhere.
No, you ain't lying.
Yeah, I put a Popeyes over there on over there by, you know, the Walmart shopping center over here. They just threw a Popeyes like randomly, like in the woods somewhere. I was like, bro, I'm like nobody going here. Then I went to that bit. That line was like down the street.
Exactly, bro.
It's a Popeyes
exactly.
Oak Leaf.
You know, anywhere.
Oh yeah.
What it is that damn chicken sandwich. Now that
that shit nasty though.
Oh yeah, it definitely is. It's too damn salty for one.
Hey, bro. Speaking of chicken sandwiches, bro, that Zaxby's one is mid.
Yeah, I ain't tried it yet. I ain't tried.
First of all, that shit like too big. That shit like a chicken hawk.
I'm gonna tell y'all who fucked the bag up. KFC. KFC had.
You the only nigga I know eat KFC
with the double down.
Talk about it. The double down. I ate a double down.
It was the Crispy Kernel, man. That shit was fire.
I ate a double down. My life hasn't been the same since I ate that double down.
Because you a fucking coon.
I thought it was stupid.
Cool ass nigga.
This shit was crazy because when I ordered that bit, they were like, you want a what? Like, I want a double down.
Yeah,
like,
I was like.
It was like, hey, we gotta advertise. We ain't think nobody actually ordered this shit,
bro. You know what's funny?
That's the
I didn't eat KFC like for a very long time. When the double down came out and all of that shit, and there was a lot of hype around their sandwiches, they were trying all kinds of shit. I never ate KFC, right? I'm a grown ass man. Man, goddamn, boy, I be riding past KFC sometimes. I be like, boy, I got to stop, man. I got to stop. Y'all tried their new fries?
No, man.
Hey, man, the bitches.
I didn't know they made new fries,
bro. I drink KFC like Arby's, bro.
I was like, damn, y'all got rid of the little waffle fries, the little wedges. And they say, yeah, we got these new fries. We ain't got no more wedges.
I'll let you
the
read
wedges the last, was the best part.
John,
of
I'll let you read the last two comments. Read them out loud, please.
Joe died, killing him. Nigga, eat KFC still. You a yaku for eating KFC?
I agree with that, man. Stop eating the KFC, bro.
Nah, man. All right.
What?
I'm gonna stop.
All right, this nigga lying, man. He going to KFC after this?
Not if you ride. I had by, plans. Like, I gotta to stop.
I had plans.
Hey, one of y'all follow him when y'all leave it out. Make sure you don't go to KFC, bro.
He thinking about the Krispy Kreme right now.
Man, look. All I know is this: they got rid of that damn Krispy Kreme. Yeah, Krispy Kreme. And
Jesus Christ.
Boy, that liquor might be touching me now. But they got rid of that shit. And I say, what the fuck? Excuse me? I would say, yeah, my bad. I'll try this sandwich. I was so motherfucking mad. Everybody trying to be like Popeyes, and Popeyes fucked up big time.
Yeah, Popeyes, fuck yeah, everybody got a chicken sandwich.
Shit, so
McDonald's got one. Burger King got one.
McDonald's got
one. Nigga, Red Lobster just came out with one.
That shit between two biscuits.
Dead fuck shit.
That been on a cheddar biscuit?
Yeah. I was about to say that been on a big ass cheddar biscuit. They just got a big ass chicken breast. They ain't even extend the cheddar biscuit. They just open that bit and say, fuck it,
bro. If I want a breast sandwich, now that shit gotta be attached to the bone, bro. Like the hood shit, bro.
For real?
Man, look at that shit, bro.
I'm still sadiddy, bro.
That looks crazy.
That's crazy. Like, bro, for the longest, I didn't even know you could have breast sandwiches with no bone on it, bro. Because I was so used to getting them with the bone on it.
Yeah.
A whole big fried chicken sandwich, bro. Yeah. Well, chicken breast.
That's how all the shit was back in, like, the hood shit. Mm-hmm. Like, you get a pork chop sandwich, that bitch had a bone on it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And you get to eating that bitch, and you...
You got to eat around the bone.
You trying to bite the hell out of that motherfucker.
Tears all shit up.
Like, shit. Hey, what's that you nibbling on over there? Well, it's got a bone in the middle of this. Just give me a minute and I'll be able to get past it.
Shit, eating fish with the bones,
Oh, man.
Real sandwich with the bone?
You fuck around and swallow one of them little catfish bones. Mm-hmm. Like,
now, you an ignorant nigga.
Save me.
If you eat the rib sandwich like a sandwich,
oh, yeah.
You better take the bread off.
You got to.
Yeah, the bread is decoration, bro.
I ain't gonna lie, I tried it the first time I ate one. I'm saying, the first time I ate a Jenkins sandwich, I was like, boy, that be good.
Nigga, teeth fell out like Tom and Jerry.
Bro, I felt like the Flintstones, like the nigga was eating rocks.
I was just eating the McRib.
Yeah, bro.
Man, I remember one time, it was like when I was a little ass kid, we was out in country ass something. Carolina, and I'm hungry as fuck, so I'm like, hey man, I want some Burger King. They look at me like, where you see a Burger King at in this motherfucker? Yeah. All you see is trees and woods and shit. Like, where you see a Burger King at?
For real?
I'm like, well, motherfucker, I'm hungry. So I'm like, Jackson, we eat Burger King and McDonald's. He's like, nah. So these niggas done killed, they didn't gonna slaughter the pig.
Nah.
So they done chopped the pig up. So I'm like, fuck it, I'm still hungry. So I'm like, fuck it. Y'all niggas, I like, nigga, I need a brisket sandwich. They're like, nah, this ain't no Burger King. And I just had to starve until, like, later on. I was like, damn.
I had a good-ass brisket sandwich on Sunday. Good-ass brisket sandwich.
You wouldn't want that brisket, because I seen they put the damn hatchet between the pig eyes.
Yeah, I believe
that. I'm like, bro, kill that nigga in the woods.
For real.
I tell you what shot me, that Bucky's gas station spot.
I heard
nigga,
about
that
it.
That was a good-ass brisket sandwich, bro. Shit look like fucking Walmart.
Where is it at? It's out in St. Augustine, isn't
it's
it?
It's one in St. Augustine. I went to the one in Daytona I was coming back.
Okay.
They got one here?
Bucky's.
It's one in St. Augustine.
It's coming. Yeah, coming to Jax. Sawgrass.
I went to Bucky's in Texas. I didn't know they was here.
Now they just came out. Yeah,
I'm going to put everybody on game now because I keep my ear to the streets. Supposedly, Bucky's be paying For real, like.
They put that bitch like, they got a sign telling you how much they paying.
I think his starting salary is like, I mean, they starting hourly is like $18 or some
shit. Yeah, they say all that shit. They say we pay our folk to work.
Yeah.
Them boys got 20 feet of jerky.
If I'm not mistaken, you gotta wear a cowboy outfit, though.
Hey, man, you better yee-haw on that motherfucker.
You gotta dress like Martin when they turn what's up into a country station.
Hey.
Change that nigga name to Marty Mar.
And that bitch talking like Woody from Toy Story.
For real.
Talking like Woody from a Toy Story for 18 an hour, dog. I respect that.
Oh, matter of fact, it might have your ass singing, "You Got a Friend in Me."
Well, how old are you, partner? There's a snake in my boots.
Like, need me to brain anybody? Like, no, nigga.
You point me bitch, to this house.
I just want fucking gas to pump down.
You want some Texas Roadhouse biscuit?
No.
But yeah, I had went to Bucky's in Texas. That shit was ignorant. I ain't never seen no shit like that.
Bro, that shit got 100 motherfucking gas pumps.
You got 100 gas pumps?
100 gas
pumps? You think I'm bullshit. They got 100 gas pumps out there, bitch. Then you think you finna walk in there just gonna pay for some gas, bro. You got 20 feet of jerky in this motherfucker. Deer jerky, gator jerky, beef jerky.
Jerky?
They got people in that bit whipping up chocolate and sweets. Niggas on the grill in that bit. Yeah, niggas like, on the grill in this motherfucker like making brisket.
30 kinds of banana pudding.
Man,
that shit ignorant.
But they got a full on clothing store in that bitch. Them niggas selling Chevys in that bitch.
That sounds similar to the little B joint too.
Like the Busy B joint.
Yeah.
But it's bigger than that shit.
That's crazy.
Nigga Busy B only
and
got
and
like
I fuck
50.
With Busy B.
Busy B was fire.
They restrooms is actually clean, bro. They ain't lying about that shit.
But Bucky, I ain't seen no Busy B.
Them motherfuckers is
yeah,
well,
Busy B.
It's supposed to be one. Yeah, it's supposed to be one St. Augustine, but it's normally, I used to go when I used to go to like Tallahassee and shit.
Yeah, it's out 10, like live oak and shit.
Mm-hmm. Got you, okay.
But Bucky's right there by the Golf Hall of Fame shit. Whatever.
Fuck all that shit. Bring back Lil Champ.
Hey, man.
Oh, Lil Champ was undefeated.
Bring back Lil Champ. Lil Champ was undefeated.
Bring back Lil Champ.
Bro. I used to want to stop just because.
Nice little hood store. Yep. That's it.
You see that sign on the highway? You like, oh, I want to stop there.
Nigga, that's the store I want. Nigga.
Quarter Water.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sure.
The chips be old as fuck, but still, man.
It's like, damn, how y'all everywhere and it's still hood as fuck?
Shit, it was only one of the few spots where you can get rap snacks back in the heyday.
For real.
You had to go to Lil Champ to get them bitches. That or like the hoodest corner store. That ain't had no name.
Like, how come the Lil Champ on Soutel the only one with the Romeo with the braid chips? Like, man, every time I come in this Lil Champ, they only got the Saint Lunatic rap chips. Like, nigga, y'all niggas just got the St. Lunatics and the Petey Pablos. I want the Romeos, too.
Shit, you gonna get what we get, goddamn.
Who all had raps now? Did Mike Jones have some? No. I could be lying.
Mike Jones had no raps.
Soldier Slim had.
So it was Romeo.
St. Lunatics.
What, St. Lunatics?
Didn't
I know Soldier Boy had a set of rap snacks.
Soldier Boy, had
Soldier Boy had to have some rap snacks.
No, by the time Soldier Boy came out, it was just Romeo. They had the little blue bags.
Oh, remember that time we finding rap snacks?
Yeah, cause see, Stan and they have rap snacks back in Douglas at the time. So we found the business over there on Dunn at the motherfucking Lil Champ.
I bought my 12 bags, bro.
That nigga bought that bitch his first bag. That nigga on that bitch out like a trophy.
I
got a picture, but I can't tell who the fuck these is.
I could have sworn I saw the Slim Head. Mm.
Pretty Willie? Who the fuck is that?
Oh, Pretty Willie? That's P-Dub, Four Walls and shit.
Warren G. Warren G got arrested. Yeah. Who is this? Miss 2? I don't know who that is.
I know Pretty Willie, that nigga from MySpace.
Wait, this one?
Southern Crump Barbecue. Who is that? Young Bloods? Oh, yeah.
They're like them franchise boys. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, shit. They got a slutty vegan lady got some rap snacks. That's fire.
I heard about that. Yeah, that's fire.
That's fire. Shout out to Rap Snacks, man. We need some R.E.O.P. rap snacks, bro. Pause, Joe. Pause. What would your flavor be? Pause.
Pause, bro.
I feel wild asking you that. What would your flavor be?
Damn, that's a really good question. I don't know, man. It'd probably be like something
ignorantly spicy.
Yeah, I was just about to say that. Some jalapeno something or something, man. I ain't never had a banana flavored chip. Banana pepper flavored. Oh, that's what I meant to say. That's what I meant to say.
Yeah, like a Cajun flavor and shit.
Like a crab
chip or something.
That'd be fine.
I forgot Young Jock had. Yeah, that is that the one we got? Young Jock, or was it Lil Romeo that was on your shit?
It was the Lil Romeo ones. That's all they had.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah,
I forgot. That's crazy. They gave Pretty Willy one. That nigga only had like two songs.
But that was the original bag too.
Yeah, he must have cut a deal or something. I don't know who this nigga is. This is like a regular.
He was just MC Potato, bro.
MC Potato. He was like, we can't afford to put a rapper, so we better just make a
nigga made up a character, bro. MC Potato.
That's ridiculous.
Hey, man, just slap some headphones on a potato.
Slap a hoodie on the nigga, bro.
What a big ass champion hoodie on a potato, bro. Fuck it, bro. They got potato. Niggas on the ones and twos with potato heads. First of all, this shit say education is dollars. Like, get this dumbass bag out of here.
Dumbass potato off my bag, man.
I forgot about the Migos one. I think the Migos had the best flavor, like, ever.
Wait, the Dab Ranch ones. Who is Dirk McGurk? Because he got one.
Older than the Bastard. ODB.
Didn't know that.
Yeah, you had changed his name. Cause you couldn't, for whatever reason, you couldn't say bastard. I almost got my ass beat one time saying that.
Saying old dirty bastard.
Yeah.
I can believe that.
Oh, I didn't know that was a code word.
I didn't either, actually. And that's how I ended up calling the pastor a bastard.
Yeah, bro. You knew it was a cuss word, can you say that?
No, I didn't, bro. I didn't know it was a cuss word. I just thought it was a really strong word. You know what I mean? Like,
he was a badass.
Like dude. That? Yeah. Yeah, I was terrible. I was terrible, and I'm not proud to say that. But, you know, I was watching The Simpsons, and I was a very young age. And, you know, Bart kept calling Homer a bastard. And in my head, I'm thinking, yo, they don't let kids cuss on TV. I've never seen a cartoon where kids are cussing on TV. You know what I'm saying? So I didn't know the difference of adult cartoons, you know? Mm-hmm. And bastard. My grandmother took me to church. She wasn't, she was trying to get me to go inside and telling me like, yo, come on in. All right, I'm going to leave you out here. I'm about to go get the pastor. Pastor came out there. I'm running around doing my thing. He grabbed me up. I said, man, get your hands off me, you bastard. Oh. He threw his hands up quick. Oh, my God.
It's a demon jet.
That's probably what he thought.
Pray for this little nigga.
My grandmother said, I don't know where that came from. I don't know where he learned that. I don't know what's going on. And First of all,
the pastor grabbing you.
Well, he was trying to get me to, like, calm down. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, I'm walking around the parking lot big dog. You know what I mean? My grandmother went inside the church. You know what I mean? I kind of got what I wanted in the sense I didn't want to go to Bible study or whatever. It's like a Wednesday night. You know what I mean? So I'm like, yo, look, I'm out here. I'm doing my thing. I'm a kid. I'm having fun in the parking lot by myself. Came and grabbed me up. Get your hands off me, pastor. I'll never forget his look. So, man, years later, I'm probably like 14. I'm in Pensacola. The pastor comes over to my grandmother's house. And he walks in, and I'm like, oh shit. I go in the room. So I'm talking to my younger brother. I'm like, hey man, let's just hang out in here, right? The pastor comes in to greet us, and he immediately goes to my younger brother. He's like, I remember you. You called me a bastard. So I'm behind my brother like, hey, just roll with it, man. He already saying it. You know what I'm saying? You ain't in trouble or nothing. Like, I'm mouth talking all of this shit out. And hoping that he can read my lips. And he turns around and he says, hey, do you remember, you know, what's your name again? My grandmother walks in as soon as, like, he's about to walk out and says, oh, you remember Joseph? He called you a bastard. I almost spit my water out. And dog, I was standing there like, fuck, here we go. Like, I done very much so disrespected this man. And now I'm lying to him blatantly in his face. Like,
man, just, to a man of God.
Bro. Yeah, a man of God, man. I'm not jeez, proud.
Well, you going to hell, man. Let me go. Man.
Struck down, man. Hey, man, I'm trying to repent. You know what I'm saying?
All right, man. Let's get to the second listening question. This one from Donnie. He said, all right, my niggas, I need real legitimate answers on an even playing field in a 1v1 versus battle. Give me a rap record that can legitimately beat Back That Ass Up by Juvenile.
Nothing.
That can beat that ass
up. Back that ass up. Name me one record that you hear in the club. That will stop you in your tracks.
Yeah, it isn't.
I'm gonna say this.
No.
At 30 years old, I'm still putting my drink down to get to the dance floor and do my thing. You know what I'm saying?
To like, get danced on, clearly.
Right.
That's how you about to.
Nah, I'm saying, like, I'm finna grab somebody up.
You're about to bust some moves.
I don't know, man.
Yeah,
boy, but stop.
You about to sell some Boy Scout cookies.
And I don't fuck too many hoes to ever pause that shit.
Hey, Stan, hit that button, bro.
Green ass nigga.
Stan.
Hey, y'all know what?
Stan, bro. Stan, bro. I thought you was my man, bro.
Hey, bro.
Uh-oh.
It was about to be a chair action part two. In
this uh-oh. Movie.
That was funny as when we hit them with that chair. <I'm pretty sure. laughs> I had to take the chair out of here after that.
I still don't know what came over me.
God damn. That's really hard. I really cannot think of another song.
Yeah, I tried to think of one. I just can't.
Yeah, it ain't one, bro.
Not even, yeah. I was really trying to think if there was something that Jeezy might have had, but there's nothing.
Nah.
Because,
man, don't hit me with a cheddar.
Oh,
I gotta see. I gotta see what's.
You my dog, bro.
That's funny. I tried, because you remember when Manny Fresh went away with Scott Storch? All the corny up north niggas was like, oh, he beat Manny Fresh. Like, Manny Fresh played back that ass up.
That beat, that Trump, that's a Trump card.
They could play like Lean Back or something. That's a Trump card. No, they were like, oh, Scott got that round.
That's a Trump card. Nah. Back That Ass Up is a record that the instant you hear it, the instant that, like, those two, it's like, okay, I know what's about to come. And let me turn around. Either you got two thoughts in your head. Where's my girl at? Or where's the closest chick that's finna throw, like, not just like dance on me. She gotta like throw that ass around very raunchily.
I don't know if that's a word, but I'm rocking with you.
I'm rocking with you, man. That shit better be raunchy. Whatever.
That word is nasty.
Yeah, what'll be close is Tip Drill, but shit, Tip Drill is a trash song, bro. Or Shake That Monkey.
I still believe P-Poppin' better than Tip Drill.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm a P-Poppin' truther.
Nah, Shake That Monkey better than both of them.
That's a too short one.
Mm-hmm.
They don't play that much down here.
Nah. I heard that shit a lot in Georgia, though. A whole lot.
Yeah, and Pensacola, too.
See, I was thinking about Lil Jon, because I love Who You With, but it's a different feel. It's up there, it's still different, though. Like, Who You With, like, you clearing out, you know, Q-Dawg's getting out there, you finna clear their ass out the way, right, like, nigga, this on some set shit. Like, I don't give a fuck.
Get y'all stomping ass out of here,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah. This for the real niggas, bro.
I just feel like this, like, you can level up the energy with all of those records that you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
But the instant you play back that ass,
motherfuckers run to the flow for that.
Like, the entire mood changes of the, like, the entire mood of the party changes.
Yeah.
Women are thinking, okay, now I'm really finna show something. Men are thinking, okay, let me get on something. Again, let me go do my thing. Yeah, I'm finna match the quickest thing.
That type of appeal. It's like, don't love the song that's gonna get close to that is really like some stomping a nigga out shit.
Right.
Because the only other song that got a similar trajectory to me is Finito. Mm-hmm. Like, I'll never forget that shit, bro. These niggas in New York almost caved this motherfucking club in when they got to that New Jersey line. Like, niggas ran in the club, knocking over security to come hear this bitch just to shout out, we gonna blow New Jersey up, and walk out that bitch.
I'm gonna blow Pensacola up.
What a chair.
Hey, you see, bro, you should have seen how he looked at you, bro.
Look at the blue chain.
He want to kill you, dog.
Nigga, what?
I ain't even gonna say nothing about Pensacola now, bro.
Right.
What?
Where'd that come from?
I don't know, bro. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Man, this might be the last episode. Put this nigga through this table.
Hey, bro.
I don't know what came over me, man.
Hey,
bro.
Dog, that's crazy.
I don't know what happened, bro.
Bro, Joe head was like.
Because at first, I ain't gonna lie. I was looking at the Patreon list, and I wasn't even listening for a second. Then this nigga say,
hey, bro, it's my Finito remix, man. Let's get to the last listening question, man. Hey, man, calm down, man. This one from Jamal Shakur. We just talking about Jamal. If you could body swap with any person for 24 hours, who would you choose and why? Pretty interesting. I don't know, nigga.
Wait, what?
Body swap with somebody.
Body swap with somebody.
Like, just how they body, like, be.
Bro, your face is like, nigga, look confused. Like, nigga, how you body swap with no nigga?
Like, nigga,
what you mean, nigga?
He been watching that, what's that song with Lil Dicky and Chris Brown?
Oh, I think it was just called Chris Brown Body or something like that.
Yeah, he been watching that shit too.
Oh, much. The video when they switched, they switched up.
Yeah, body swap with.
I body slam a nigga, but I don't know about body swap.
Yeah, I mean, living somebody else's life.
I'll body swap with somebody and fuck their life up. Somebody I hate.
All right. So here's the question. Let's say. Damn, how could this work?
Would you body swap with the nigga that stole them Jordans just to see his feet blown up and switch back?
Oh, yeah. If I knew I could switch back, nigga, I'd dive on that landmine. Nigga, this a reset button when he die? I go back? What? He ain't got to die. No. Because he need to live without his feet. I'm a tiptoe over. And, like, I'm just make sure both feet gone.
Yeah, I body swap with somebody and like fuck their credit up, buy like a bunch of dumbass shit,
and then send it to yourself.
Yeah, frame a murder on that fuck nigga. Stab somebody up. Go. Now and that's put a knife up. In their closet.
That's fucked up.
And hope they get caught the next day.
This nigga, you got this evil.
If I'm getting body swapped, like, no, I'll do some evil up. Shit.
And see, I ain't even. That's no crazy.
Franchise Radio Shack.
I can respect it though, man. You just want, like, at least I got reason for my hateful shit.
This you a damn demon.
Yeah, for real.
I can't see myself swapping with somebody's body and just be like,
bro, real shit.
I'm in a nigga body.
Real shit. You have like role models and shit growing up, but I don't look at nobody and be like, damn, bro, I want to be like that.
Man. Right, yeah, right, bro. Right.
Mm. Nah.
Only thing I can say is I would want like the lifestyle, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. All right, well, let's do it that way.
Okay, so because it's easy to say.
What you say now.
I think honestly speaking.
They think about it, say I'm gonna swap with Mr. Marcus or some shit like that.
Man, chill out. Chill out. Don't be casting onto me.
that's what I was gonna say.
I really want to say this, but
you got me.
I'd say Rick Ross. I like his lifestyle, man. Honestly.
Yeah, he'd be Rick Ross.
I just wouldn't want to be.
Up the Wingstop every week.
You know what I'm saying? Eating fried foods, have my Maybach.
Eating a big Buffin and a Maybach sound fire.
Yeah, and then, you know, I just got to have more soup. Oh.
Do I got the Rick Ross drop on here? I think I got the Rick Ross drop on here.
Come on, drop that thing one time.
I don't think I got it no more. Oh, yeah. I still got it.
Well, that's fine.
Okay.
You gotta say that.
I don't touch the boys no more.
Oh yeah, I took that off.
Yeah, I
took it off.
Hey, look, that shit did too many numbers,
Joe,
man.
Joe, like, a viral sensation,
right,
bro? Some people be doing like duets to that video. You know the TikTok duets where people be like side by side.
Yeah,
I'll pull one up.
That's funny.
Like, nigga,
that's funny as fuck.
Lifestyle I don't want to have, bro.
Now, I'm going to tell you another one that I would have loved to, like, live in that lifestyle. Allen Iverson. Oh, yeah. When he was really, first came into the league.
Yeah.
You just stole mine.
Iverson.
Yeah. Just the game when he was getting his hair braided. I'll be AI when he stepped over Tyronn Lue.
Yeah.
But I would have stepped on that nigga thigh.
That reminds me of that TV show, that Disney TV show, The Jersey.
Oh, yeah.
Probably be like.
Damn, I forgot about that show.
Like LeBron and Game 6 in Boston or some shit like that. That'd be fun.
Because he like, oh, nah, damn. That, oh, my God. Or when they retired Paul Pierce jersey.
Yeah, bro. He was staring into that nigga's soul, bro, with every shot.
Yeah, they did them dirty that night.
I swapped Paul Pierce bodies when he had them bitches the other week.
Yeah, bro.
I swapped dirty.
That's funny.
Not none of his games when he had them hoes the other
week.
I switched dirty. That nigga, he was having a time.
His job on the line again. You know,
you ain't see Paul the other day. That nigga ain't old. He got his own grow farm now.
For real?
Yeah, that nigga living it up now.
Oh, damn, that's what's up.
That nigga smoked weed for the first time last week. Yeah, fuck it.
Yeah,
we going all in.
Hey, when you got it, you got it.
Mm. Truth, yeah. Kush.
Yeah, that's an easy seller.
That all? That's all y'all got, man? Listen? I mean, not listen to question, but for all to answer that question before we move on. Because, yeah, pretty much that's it.
Yeah, that's really it, bro. I can't think of that.
I swapped bodies with Tupac on that faithful ride and tell Suge, hey man, turn right.
True. Yeah.
Yeah. This nigga foul, bro.
Hey, turn right, my nigga, and don't go down there. It's not a good idea. Turn right right here, bro. Turn to the in and out right here, bro. I'm hungry.
Hey, make them niggas meet us here.
Exactly.
Where we get inside somewhere.
Let's do Patreon shout outs, man.
All right.
I'll let you hit the button.
That's,
nah, like a
man, it ain't on the right
page.
All right,
got it.
I see it.
Last time I got it, but last time I put the name and you still
hit it. I ain't see it, man. I was sitting over there. Well, look. Lately, I've been out here working all night, man. I've been like a trooper. Shout out to my main man, DJ Black. Man, look. Said I've been working all night, I'm a fucking trooper. Shout out to my main man, the Black DB Cooper. Then we got Dean. Sorry if a nigga seem mean, but Amp say one more fucking thing about Pensacola, and I'ma have to clean his head off his shoulders. I just had to say that, and then shout out Psychosis. I'ma go psycho if this nigga say one more thing I don't like though. Then we got Big Tim in a fucking pair of Tims. I'ma stomp Amp out if he say something about Pensacola again. Yo, bro, this might be a whole diss record about you with names just sprinkled into it. Eric Combs. Then we got Big Mike. I'm in Amp home. He might go home. I mean to the upper room. Big Doom. Then we got Heavy D. And we got today Austin. Vince 23. And we got Sam. And we got Cam. When I get Amp out of here, y'all gonna say damn. Anthony. Then we got Straight. I'ma send Amp the other fucking way. And Still Barn and Kojo, the Sky Dweller, and King Joe. I mean King Joseph. I don't mean no disrespect. When I say Tremaine, I mean my fucking main. And we got Tim, and we got Frank, Chris Tokyo. Tell me where you wanna go. Talking about Japan, I got a plan. Tamal Shakur, that's my fucking man. He in the mail room, he give a damn about your fucking mail. That's why you ain't got it yet. And we got Adam, All-Star Garcon. That nigga got a couple rugs coming soon. And we got Gerard, I was reading too fast. God, and we got KD shooting from the three. Banks. Y'all see how it cut off on Banks. So did that hair. Man, China Dan. And we got Trap. And I'll say one more thing again, he gonna get slapped. And we got Joshua. And we got Toph. I've been out here. Tag Ken Tokes. And we got Tristan. And we got Millie. Chloe Hotline shit. I've been going silly. And we got Steven. What do you believe in? Nico. He been Puerto Rican though. And we got Ryan. Then we got Nick. Darius. He the next one up in this bitch. And we got Cameron. And Paperwork Sam. He got some Balenciagas. I was like, damn. Then we got Rand. Kareem in this thing. Kareem probably shooting with a hook in this thing. And we got Stephon. Then we got TC. He gonna get DQ'd if I talk about DQ. And we got Shavante. And we got Earl. He probably been around the world in the fucking Air Maxes. But then we got Key. Hey, Slice, Bread, Corey, Alonzo, and we got Deadstock Dev, and we got Candace. I think I named them all. I was trying to think of what could rhyme with Candace.
Let me ponder. I don't know.
Nothing that would go in the Patreon shout outs.
You was dissing me a lot but I respect it, bro.
Yeah, bro. You said a lot of things about Pensacola over the last like few weeks and months, and I ain't like it. So this is my
too bad. Sign up to the Patreon. Patreon.com/ Ari Podcast. Now, we got one of our Patreon subscribers in the building right now. Shout out to Stan.
Hit Stan, him with the applause. Fucking man.
Shout out to Stan.
I'm going to slap Amp if he say one more thing again.
All right, man. This nigga something else, man. Let's get in the real niggas of the week and they need their ass beats. And get up out of here, bro. to send in those, just hit us up at mail@ariopodcast.com. That's mail@ariopodcast.com. Or if you're one of our amazing Patreon subscribers and you in our Discord, our private Discord, we got a section where you can leave everything. I could have sworn I had my shit. One of y'all got to go before me because I ain't got mine set up because I had it on here, but it's not. One of y'all nigga deleted my shit?
No, nigga.
All right, man.
I mean, the only one I thought about was Gunna and Thug.
That's the one I had.
Yeah.
Gunna and Thug, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I don't think I got one.
I don't have a real nigga of the week this week. Except for, I mean, I'm not gonna do it because we need to talk about that, you know, soon. But I do have a They Need They Ass beat.
Of course you do, violent ass nigga.
Man, shut the fuck up.
All right.
Well, I give Dr. Umar my real nigga of the week for that Breakfast Club interview.
Oh, that's a good one.
You about to get
that's
us canceled, good one. Man.
Nah, that's a good one. He was dropping some big facts.
Man, Dr. Umar killed that shit, but of course, you know, it's Dr. Umar, so niggas think anything Dr. Umar say, they don't like it, man. Even though, because, like, he was just basically talking about how Joe Biden really didn't do shit for us. He was mostly talking about also how a lot of the time in these black schools that they consider kids, they call them, they classify them as remedial and whatnot. They put them in special classes just because they have issues with one teacher. And he dropped a book and he was telling people, like black parents, on how to find out if their kids are putting in special classes and they don't need to be in classes like that, but like quote unquote behavioral classes. But
yeah, he got like answer keys or some shit in the book that you could like, he said you could compare like for each section of like the little standardized test they give you. To try to diagnose you, so he can he broke it down or some shit like that. But yeah, Dr. Umar.
Yeah, and I think I just got my real nigga of the week. I forgot about it. My man's went to go bond out his homie, and you know he was on Snapchat. He let us know bonding out my boy.
Yeah, I seen that shit.
Yeah, and then his bond was $89,000. The nigga said, "Never mind, he good inside."
It was
$89,000, bro.
That's too much, bro.
Cause his bond was $888,000.
I'm sorry, bro. You gotta fight that case.
I said that wrong, but you get what I'm saying. $1,100. Yeah.
The fuck did he do?
Hey, Don in the chat, he said, yo, I've been a Patreon subscriber for a couple months. Your nigga's about to be the They Need Their Ass Beat. I ain't been on the shout out yet. I just looked it up, bro. You got a $5 tier, man. You got to be on a 10 and up to get the shout outs. So sorry for the misunderstanding, but yeah, you got to be 10 and up.
Hey, but I'm going to say this, LaDon.
Let's shout you out, man.
I can respect you checking this nigga.
Who, me?
Yeah, nigga.
Hey, man. Hey, better drop a mother disc.
LaDon been coming strong. I felt like I had to come and do another song. Elp need a slap. Elp need some dap. Nah, fuck that. Elp need Godzilla to come crap in his fucking room. I mean, damn doom. Alonzo, you remember what I had said? Help me that same shit up on his head.
Alright.
Ugly ass boy.
That's how you feeling, sir?
That's how I'm feeling, man.
Right, that's bad.
Like, I ain't fucking with you right now. Alright,
man.
Like, that Joe, shit was unnecessary.
Joe rapping like
man.
Blind Fury right now.
Let's do submissions there. But yeah, Gunna and Thug for sure. They bonded out 30 people?
Yeah, 30.
Yeah, with non-violent offenses. So,
that's
yeah.
Fire.
That's fire.
All right. This one is from B-Dot. So a young lady, she tweeted, This kid just pulled out a 12-count pack of Hawaiian sweet rolls out of his book bag. And P-Dot got him as the real nigga of the week. I think that's one of the kids Dr. Umar was talking about that might have behavioral issues. If a kid pulled out a 12-pack of Hawaiian sweet rolls and start eating them, we might have to put him in a special class. There's something going on at home if you're eating a 12-pack of Hawaiian sweet rolls with no chicken at all. He ain't had no Publix chicken in his bag. Nigga just had Hawaiian sweet rolls. Like, did he have a drink at least? Might be something going on with that kid emotionally.
Oh, man, that's
oh. Bitch in that bridge pulling out a pull on.
And then you gotta take
like, damn, that's a lot of bread, bro.
Oh shit, like, bro.
I don't know what you say to that.
With no drink.
Oh yeah, that nigga asking to die.
Jesus.
He dehydrated, bro. At the end of that.
Bro.
That's crazy. Shout out to that kid, I guess. I don't know, man. Yeah, appreciate you, Don, man. Let's. Who else I got? And they need to ask me. Not they need to ask me. Real niggas of the week. Paperwork Sam. So of course this is Paperwork Sam. It's gonna be something fucking ridiculous. So let's say new dash cam footage shows one of the suspects in a speeding incident opened fire with the AK-47 on three Carroll County cops. So of course, yeah. So. Let's play it.
Hey, let's move down. Let's move down. Let's move down. Come on.
Yeah, it's the kid on Mary.
God damn.
God damn.
They're like Seek Almighty. You
let that bitch fly.
It does. Nowhere with that bitch.
That looks like them.
I ain't see it. That nigga pull that shit.
He pull it out of nowhere, bro.
He pull out the back of his pants? Because he's walking regularly. He ain't got nothing to do.
That motherfucker fly.
What's bruh name for Snow on the Bluff? Damn, it's on the tip of my tongue.
Dog, Snow. Dog got
Curtis 10. Snow, yeah.
Dog that's got Curtis 10 Snow. GTA stars for that shit.
Yeah, for real. Damn.
All right, this is another one from Paperwork Sam.
Yeah. Well, I've been here all four nights. I'm just standing here today with soup for my family. And we're just, you know, watching all of this unfold. It's very unfortunate.
You're not planning on using that, are you, throwing it at the police?
Like I said, it's for my family. It's
literally for your family.
And then when they get caught, they say, no, this is soup for my family. They're so innocent. This is soup for my family. It's incredible. And you have people coming over with bags of soup, big bags of soup.
All right, so they were protesting in, I guess it was Minnesota, I guess. So, like, you know, people walking around with cans of soup.
Yeah. To
throw it at police officer's head. And, like, I guess he said it was soup for his family, which was kind of odd because the nigga just walking around 10 o'clock at night with some Campbell's soup.
With a Campbell's.
I don't know, I'm hungry. All right, this one's from Rand. So this nigga, he was getting sentenced, and I guess it was over Zoom. So this nigga was in a barbershop getting a fade while getting sentenced. And they got no audio or nothing to it. I think we have to put this nigga in the real nigga Hall of Fame because he said, fuck it. I know y'all trying to give me 10 years, but I got to get this fade in.
That's crazy.
I respect it.
That's crazy. The judge looks stressed the fuck
she
out.
She ain't even saying that. She's looking at this nigga, bro.
I can't believe.
That's crazy.
Nigga laughing. She probably get that nigga. It's probably like a speeding ticket. She probably get that nigga electric chair. All right, this one's from Donnie. He got Jackie Chan as his real nigga of the week. So, say Jackie Chan plans to leave his estimated $370 million to charity. And not for his son, JC. Chan explained, if he is capable, he can make his own money. If he is not, then he will just be wasting time. I mean, wasting mine. So that nigga Jackie Chan said, fuck it, my nigga. You don't know how to do no roundhouse kicks, bitch ass nigga. Get out the mud, bitch.
Yeah. I saw a video recently. He was talking about his son and like how Jackie growing up in China and how like being around parents, it was different and shit. Like, yes, sir, yes, no, sir, and all that type of stuff. And how his son is like full on American and Jackie hate that shit.
Yeah, I could believe that. Because Jackie Chan still has all of the same traditions and still runs I know up until like a year or two ago, was still a major part of like a stunt school in China.
A stunt school?
Yeah. He teaches people to become stunt artists.
You remember that G-Unit song Stunt 101?
Yeah.
Didn't it have like Brandy or somebody in the video? Like, Stunt 101. I might be the only nigga that remember that shit.
You green.
You don't green remember? Ass nigga.
You ain't listening to the G-Unit album?
No.
Stunt 101. All right, man.
I don't remember the video. I remember the Popping Them Things video.
Yeah, Popping Them Things. All right. They need their ass beats. I got this nigga Tyrese. I don't know if I played a video or not.
He was shaving some coochie.
Yeah, he had his...
on IG.
Yeah. What? I guess I'm going to play it. This girl got the camera up.
I'm supposed to be shaving, but I'm thinking about something else.
Shaving.
Dog shaving the cool pop. He wild, bro.
Big time.
Sticking your tongue out.
Now, he was using like a big razor, right?
Hey, man.
Ad time. Manscaped.com. Go to manscaped.com. Use that promo code REOP. And don't shave your girl coochie hair with big razors.
Come on.
You use the Manscaped 3.0 trimmer. Cop one of those. Get 20% off on that by using the promo code REOP. See, Tyrese is a nasty nigga. He don't care about his woman's health. He's using nasty ass Vicks. He's disgusting. It only even look like he had no shaving cream on that shit.
Or no technique.
I don't think that nigga was shaving for real. I just think that nigga just a weirdo.
Oh, we know that. I mean, he painted a picture of Malcolm X baptizing Tupac.
Nigga, you don't get over that, man. My next thing need their ass beat.
Martin Luther King was the son.
It's just a painting, bro. You ain't never went inside the flea market and seen the shirt with
that's
the
a depiction of how people be thinking.
You ever seen the old school pictures with like t-shirt niggas to wear with Bugs Bunny and some baggy jersey and shit? You ain't never looked at it and been like, damn, Bugs Bunny don't wear jeans. It's just a shirt.
No.
SpongeBob with the stacks.
Yeah.
I'd be like, nah.
You don't get paid that much at Krusty Krab.
Yeah, but his show did. And he is an actor in a cartoon realm. I remember. What's that movie, Who Framed Roger Rabbit? When they go off set, what happens to SpongeBob? You think he doing the money stretch?
No, we'll find out in Space Jam 2.
Right.
I don't think sure. Yeah, I don't think SpongeBob would be in that bit, but still.
Nah. He ain't in that, but shit.
What was that? What was that other one that came out around Who Framed Roger Rabbit? Cool World. You remember that one? You had to be a sicko if you seen that one.
Bro, I can't recall.
It was like one where it was like a dope version of like Who Framed Roger Rabbit with like cartoon. Like the nigga was like fucking the cartoon girl.
Wow.
It had
Oh, that's wild.
It had whatchamacallit in it. He was the main dude.
Yeah, you a sicko.
Who, me?
Yeah, you seen it.
Yeah, that's nasty. Bro.
This is a sick nigga.
Yeah, Brad Pitt in it, bro. That nigga, they never seen Cool World, bro. Let me pull it up. Bro. Nigga was fucking the cartoon girl. It's like she turned real after he gave her that dick.
Whoa.
This is a sick Negro.
This shit right here, bro. Y'all ain't never seen Cool World with Brad Pitt.
Man. And why are you hitting the color?
That's
chip?
Crazy.
Shit,
2.5 stars too. God damn,
that shit was ass. It was like a really bad movie. I seen it by accident because you know back in the day, you know, I feel like everybody's parents just had like movies on like cassettes that they just burnt. They just be chilling around. And that shit ain't got no label on it. Mm-hmm. You just be watching movies. Like next thing you watching Terminator. I'm watching Terminator 2, and the next thing you know, the other side of the tape got Cool World on it. I'm like, all right. Then they say, you know, I seen this nigga smashing a cartoon. I was like, oh, I don't think I should be watching this.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
That's insane.
Yeah, it's nasty, man. All right, speaking of nasty, this is my another thing need to ask be submission. It's a nigga name. It don't matter what his name is. He tweeted, "I don't care if my homie hit, I can fuck better than him."
Hey, oh, yo, like for real.
When I seen him throw that ball.
I don't know what's like. That's nasty.
What was the purpose of that, bro?
I don't know, bro.
That's nasty.
Next one is I ain't gonna say she need an ass beat, but she need to be locked away for 10 days and think about her ex. I got Saweetie. She was on something with Snoop Dogg. I don't know where the fuck she was.
Oh man, I really don't want to see this again.
Some pizza.
Ooh.
So my taste buds are really eclectic. I like everything at once. When you put hot Cheetos on some pizza, it really gives you the sensation you need to have.
Jesus.
Salud. Mm.
Hot Cheetos on the pizza? You better
disgusting.
Work.
Snoop don't want to eat
that's
that.
See, that's real work right there.
She don't want to eat that. Look at she it trying like, to keep up. She doing anything to sell her records at this point. Shit is creative. That's what this got to be.
I put top ramen seasoning on my oysters.
I don't know, bro. I think she really liked this shit.
She put what on it?
Top ramen season.
Around that shit, man.
There's no way she likes to eat like that.
Man, women be eating nasty shit, bro.
Hey, that coochie probably tart, bro.
Joe, man, who your lady to ass beat?
No, that shit tart.
I really don't know how to feel like about bringing this up, but I saw a video from a tweet that said, you know, I just saw, this is the tweet. I just seen a video of a nigga funeral. In his funeral, the niggas who he had beef with when he died came and took the casket, and I just. And I don't know if you all have seen this video.
No. Yeah, I'm not showed that bit to me yesterday. That shit crazy.
Yeah, that's insane.
Yeah. But them niggas should have been shot.
On site.
It happened in Brazil.
Brazil or something. Yeah, that's what I heard.
That's crazy, bro.
Shout out to the homie Nate number 8. He dropped a freestyle over that shit.
Funeral dressed up like a priest. Run out with my ops casket like you coming with me. I'm like, he can't die yet. He owe money to me. I'm at my ops funeral laughing. Something's funny to me. I might take his casket, grab his suit, cause I need one. He can't rest in peace yet. Lord knows what he's done. Kiss my op mama on the cheek. Sorry about your son. I would've dug him up anyways, cause I'm beamed up. I'm at the ops funeral wearing all white and tap shoes. Pray to your spirit, let you know that if you was here, I would've slapped you. I walk into the ops funeral like where the party at. I pull up to the ops funeral with a fresh shave and a party hat. I'm at the funeral like, goddamn, the music fantastic. I walk in the funeral, walk out with the nigga in the casket. We say the casket, even if the body not embalmed yet. Nigga stealing casket, you should always pay your loans back. I'm mad if you got stolen from your own funeral. I'm at the Oz funeral, defacing all the murals. I feel like money bag, yo, no cap, it's gonna be a funeral. Can't let him rest in peace because that nigga did something terrible. I might dig him up, they forgot the red nose and the clown wig. I'm thinking take the casket, go out of town with
him. All right, that's dope. I'm sorry, they slid on this shit.
He went crazy on this.
Stealing a nigga casket because you need a suit, bro. I know bruh, you felt that. You bruh, felt that.
He
that
said, I came into the funeral and left out with the nigga in the casket.
Bro, that's. Shout out to Nate, bro. You slid on that shit.
Bruh. Like, damn, I almost want that on an MP3, but that's the wrong kind of shit to be like, right, bro.
That's crazy. That's crazy. Crazy player, that, bro. Y'all got they need their ass beats? If I get to these submissions.
I got one more, man.
Who?
You, nigga.
All right, man. That was predictable.
I didn't think of
things. Do I have one? Oh, yeah. The creators of that Mortal Kombat movie.
I ain't seen that
I
shit.
I still ain't seen it. I didn't even know the bitch came up. Yeah. Till y'all was talking about.
Liu Kang was a hoe.
Bruh, they
cool.
Bruh, Sonya stayed in Gary, Indiana, bruh.
That's crazy.
As a safe haven.
She was stayed by Freddie Gibbs. That's crazy.
That shit was a gory Power Rangers movie, bro.
Yeah.
I got. I ain't see it yet. I'm probably gonna watch it tonight. You said Liu Kang was a hoe. Liu Kang always been a hoe. In the video games, he always got beat. He literally, most of the video games, that nigga been dead. He been dead like the last three video games.
He been dead since like Xbox PS2 days, bro. Since
Mortal Kombat 4, honestly.
Yeah. Nah, watch the movie and you tell me if Liu Kang, did Liu Kang live up to what you would expect of him?
I don't expect much because Liu Kang a bitch. Yeah, Liu Kang always been a hoe.
He always been about peace and shit.
Yeah, he always been like a punching bag.
Right, but this nigga looked like he was a child. Like, I mean, I hated the way they depicted Liu Kang, Jax.
I say with Liu Kang though, they probably made him look like a child because they probably based it off the first Mortal Kombat, maybe because he was a child in there.
Nah, he still was older.
He was older, but he looked like a kid in the first one. In the first game,
I should say. I got you.
But yeah, that shit was trash, bro. That shit was trash. I tried to say it was cool, but that shit was trash.
The shit that really bothered me was Jax transforming, his arms transforming. I did not understand that.
Now he's spoiling
it. Then,
Lord, spoiling it, bro. He ain't even watched it yet, bro.
You know I didn't watch it. That's why he doing it. Asshole. Yeah, man, fuck this nigga out, bro. I'm going to see the whole movie.
He gave you the cliff notes.
This nigga asshole, man.
What else you want to know?
Nah. Shut up, man. All right, so we were supposed to do this last week, but I forgot. So Adam, he got a submission. He got EDP. So EDP was exposed last week,
fucking disgusting,
as a pedophile. I don't know what else to really say about this, because I really don't want to give the dude any shine that exposed EDP, because apparently the dude that exposed EDP, he's a predator and he's a racist and he got banned off YouTube. So EDP got banned off YouTube, and this white dude that exposed EDP got banned off YouTube. So yeah, ain't really much to talk about. A nigga nasty. He tried to fuck a 13-year-old. So fuck him. So yeah, I hope he burn in hell. Did y'all watch that video of him getting exposed?
Nah, I ain't watch it.
Yeah, I watched it, man. I felt bad watching it, but yeah, the nigga tried to. First of all, he tried to fist bump the niggas. He was like, fist bump, and the dude was like, I don't fist bump people like you. But I think he was talking about black people. So yeah, fist bump black people. He wasn't talking about predators. He was talking about it because he's a nigga.
That's funny.
But yeah, fuck EDP, and that's it. This one's from Darius. He got, what's this nigga name? I forgot the nigga name. Oh, Kendrick Perkins. You got Kendrick Perkins as they need
it. Light skinned brother with the green eyes, because you know, as a dark skinned brother growing up, we all wanted to be light skinned and had the green eyes because, hey, you know, he was attracting more women. But this kid is.
What is this nigga talking about?
This is a sick Negro. He want to swap bodies with.
Yeah, that's what he want to swap bodies with. Anybody that's light. And they got cone. It's another one from, I think this one's from Darius. Nah, this one's from King Petty. All right, this nigga is a, go ahead and hit that sick Negro butt again. This nigga is in
this
prison.
This is a sick Negro.
He got sex dolls and shit in the prison.
Mermaids.
Oh, that mermaids. Nigga, I seen that shit too.
Yeah, this Seek Almighty right there.
Crazy.
You got the sex dolls in the prison. A lot of these shits is dated, though, because it's been sick for a while. I think that I don't want to play that one. Yeah, these bitches dated, man. It's holding on to them too long. This one's from Big Tim. It says, it's crazy when I'm eating some pussy. Well, Big Tim didn't say this. Somebody tweeted this. He said, it's crazy when I'm eating some pussy. And I remember hashtag Maul. He's talking about Maul from the Joe Budden podcast. Advice. Stay on the clit. Eating some coochie and thinking about another nigga advice is disgusting.
Terrible. Terrible.
This is a sick Negro.
Last one. This is another from Darius. He got Boosie as a baby dad's beat.
That nigga, that was wild.
Boosie tweeted. He's talking about he's talking about whatchamacallit.
That shit.
Boosie tweeted, he lucky he ain't going to jail in Louisiana. And then he tweeted, 2 eggplant emojis. He said, boss call would have been made. So apparently this nigga Boosie got booty goons in the Louisiana prisons. That's crazy. Mm. But he did say on the song, fuck you, what he said? He said, I'll pay my convict niggas to put that dick in your ass or something like that. he been told us what he was on. So, hey, man. And that's all that they need to ask beats, man. Shout out to everybody that submitted one. Y'all got anything? Because I'm going to get up out of here. You're about to fall asleep.
Yeah, I think that's it for your boy.
Yeah, that's it.
It's a wrap.
Y'all got anything I need to plug?
MadeInTheSouth.com.
Yeah, there you go.
Yes, sir.
And if you check last week's episode on YouTube, your boy was wearing one of the t-shirts.
I missed out, man. I need that 2X, man. As soon as I came on, you had that. You had nothing, man. You had the little nigga size.
Hey, bro, I can't, dog. I didn't expect that shit to do that.
He can't hold him. And I'm about to grab another one if I can.
Yeah, bro. Y'all niggas stay showing love, though, bro. That's real.
Yeah. I think that's like the only t-shirt that you ever sold that I missed, I think.
Yeah.
I want to say.
Yeah, you done got everything.
Yeah. No, you got anything? I know you got something to plug, nigga.
Yeah, but no, this is my nigga Stan, man. We got to get them shirts moving, bro.
Okay, Made in the South.
Yeah, this is a Stan episode, man.
I'm Made in the South, dog.
Yes, MadeInTheSouth.com. You know what I'm talking about? Mo on the way.
S-O-U-F, by the way, not T-H.
Yeah.
Oh, you say South like a real nigga.
Yeah, South.
Mm-hmm.
You got anything else coming soon? Or?
Yeah, I got some more shirts coming. I'm getting the shirts and stuff for that right now.
Yeah, man, you
got
to keep it going, man.
Yes, sir. Hell yeah.
Get back.
Oh, hell yeah, bro. I got some Jaguar shit coming next. So.
Oh, okay, Lord. Man,
yes, sir. Yes, sir, that's what we on.
We looking forward to
Yes, sir. I can't wait to lose in style. Get a fit off losing.
Did plenty of them all.
See, that's the mindset that keep brothers down.
Man, you know Jaguars ass. Hey,
shit gonna go up when we get Trevor Lawrence. Bro.
Come on, man, tell him again.
What else? 24 hours? 48 hours?
That's soon.
Yeah, 48
hours. I ain't gonna be on next week episode, but when I come back, actually, no, I'm not gonna have a Trevor Lawrence jersey because you're cool. But I'm gonna praise him in spirit because I can't buy the white man jersey. Only white man jersey I ever bought was Bart Brunell, and that's about it.
Hey, bro, just get his jersey number and put Amp on the back.
I've seen it done.
Yeah, shout out to Trevor Lawrence.
Yakubs do it.
My quarterback. Oh, yeah. I call him my quarterback, though. I ain't buying no jerseys, but that's my quarterback. Shout out to Trevor Lawrence. Let's Urban Meyer do some fuck shit.
Urban Meyer be hanging that out east, man.
He was outside whooping.
Yeah,
you know Tierra over there cooking for him and whatnot.
Pulling up
so,
on the boys, man.
I mean, trying
to look for some new wide receivers over there.
All right, so I'm gonna end it on this. Y'all might have to take my Jacksonville card away because I did not know this. So spoiler alert: this nigga Eric, he doing like a Jacksonville article for Complex. So I was helping this nigga out on that shit. Did y'all know that there's 2 whoop? There it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's a whoop. There
whoop,
it is.
Whoop. There it is.
And
a
whoop. Whoop. Yeah, I was like, nigga, I know about the 95 South. I didn't wasn't aware the tag team one.
Yeah, whoop. There it is, and then whoop.
Yeah, it's 2 of them. I was like, nigga, what the fuck? But yeah, that's interesting. But yeah, y'all be on the lookout for that Complex article. And I ain't got nothing else.
That'd be pretty cool. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I guess with all the rappers blowing up, that's probably the perfect time to do that. I helped out on one for Hypebeast a while back. I'm not sure if it ever came out. And it was like more like restaurants and shit to kind of do. But shout out there, man. Definitely about that time. Everybody doing their thing.
Yeah, it's gonna be about the positive shit, not the negative shit. So yeah,
it's a little turned up around here.
Say that for the Patreon. But with all that said, we out.
Yep.